Go live when we're doing this.
Hey!
Oh, that's live. That's
super live.
Hold on. I guess I should put this on if we're live.
Oh, I didn't notice you there.
There we go.
Welcome.
No, that doesn't work, Liam. We're in a big setup. There's like a mixer.
Yeah, actually.
Welcome to Super...
It crashed.
Yeah, it's broken.
It's broken, so...
You Steam
you
stream
for
broke.
Joining us.
Welcome to Bloodborne.
See, no, look, it's...
You fucking...
It's crashed.
This is, dude. I don't need this. My chest is already thumping.
Okay. Well, now you know how some people feel. Anyway,
I went through the same
thing. Oh man. Oh no. Oh jeez.
So are we playing Demon Souls?
No.
Something like that.
Wait. No. What's going on?
He's going on German Spy.
Hey. Greetings, everybody.
Hey, everybody.
Oh, that's your voice.
Doing it live. This is the definition of doing it live.
Oh, this is such a bad idea.
I just realized
Yes, Matt, this is my voice. I'm sorry.
Oh,
I'm sorry
that's
to disappoint
good.
You.
That's good.
Don't look.
Oh, man. So, yeah, Spy, turn
Thank
your
you.
Sound off for your
yes.
stream
so
and listen to us via Skype. That's
I
be
have,
weird.
Yes. I've learned this lesson in the past, so I'm a step ahead of you there.
Thank you.
Hey, no, wait, we're not late. We started, you hit the button at 6 o'clock.
At 6 p.m. exactly.
Yeah, exactly.
No. Who said late?
I remember.
Dude, look how fast this fucking
don't
goes.
Worry about that.
It's going
don't
pretty quick. Try not to read it.
First of all, hey, everybody, welcome to Super Best Friends stream. Thank you for tuning
My
in.
My mic always suspiciously sabotaged at the last
oh,
second.
Oh, well, no,
I
from the beginning.
This time.
I'm amazed at like how clutch you guys were at the buzzer getting in here, but you did get in on time. And
are you wearing the Matt shirt?
We are.
Yeah, I felt it the appropriate shirt
that's
for today.
It's the hypest shit.
I'm going to get this all set up here.
Oh, no.
Special shout outs to.
Why aren't you wearing yours?
I'm wearing Benny's shirt.
Special shout outs to
oh,
our
yeah,
mods.
Right, the trader shirts.
Yeah, no.
And Cranky and Mothman and Plague and all you good guys that are going to be.
Wow, there's a whole crew in there.
The whole,
why are
whole
all of
crew?
Our mods artists?
My suspiciously.
Aren't we all, Pat?
No.
What's going on, Matt? You
Matt's,
okay?
Matt's mic
just,
has been sabotaged.
It's just not weighted properly.
Oh, he
broke it.
Liam, because of Metal Slug.
Like this.
Yeah, just rotate the bar to match the bar and you're fine. Okay.
Okay.
We're going to get the game started up here.
Can you see the chat
the
anywhere on there?
I can pull it up.
I think that's fine. That's fine.
Because we should be able to see it or some shit,
yeah,
right?
There we go.
Oh, that's actually super good. God, right. That goes so fucking fast.
Yeah,
it
so
very
our
fast.
Mods are going to need to control
Sonic.
The slow mode.
Use the slow gem mods.
And they're going to need to get that all
I'm
set
paying
up.
Attention to all of you. No, I'm not. I lied. You know what I found out?
Hold on a second. Hold
what?
On a second.
No.
Yes,
fine.
I am.
Still there?
Okay.
Oh,
okay,
can,
good.
Can you bump up my volume? I can't hear
yes,
anything.
Yes, sure.
Yeah, okay.
Bump up the volume jams.
Unless German Spy is like a
bump
fanatically quiet
well, no,
person.
I'm...
No, he's quite clear.
Oh,
I'm giving you guys
now.
An opportunity to sort things out before I start running my mouth.
Oh, I see.
He sounds like a cartoon character slash like TV show host.
Yeah, totally.
If I
That's
had a nickel
great.
For every time I've been told that, Matt, I would have exactly one nickel.
You sound like a cartoon like radio show guy right now by saying that.
What
if I had a nickel for every time.
That's due to his German spy gimmick. He's
I
supposed to
so.
Sound like that.
Yeah, it's to blend in.
Yeah, blends in.
So that Eisenhower doesn't know.
So once again, Spy, please, at any time, feel free to just power right through the voices that are
yeah,
coming.
Yeah, because you're on a Skype delay, headphones. So just force it and we'll
okay.
eventually give up.
Yeah, because otherwise, getting a word in edgewise with all four of us is ridiculous.
That's no problem. I think I can manage. And Matt, it's been the whole Cold War and they haven't sniffed me out yet, so I...
Ah, good.
Great. All right.
Man, I figured out something just now looking at the stream footage. I'm super pumped. When I put these headphones on, they cover up the bald.
Kinda.
From the camera's point
from
of
the
view.
Camera's
from
point
the camera's point of view.
Kinda.
If I just do this a
but
little bit
But you guys
more.
Should know, he's very bald.
It's,
okay.
Well, in the middle, like in this part.
Yeah, it's the
like,
most
it's
embarrassing
bad.
Bit.
The most, the Costanza.
So here we go. We're booting. We're booting.
Yeah,
we're
playing
booting.
The worst we're Souls
booting.
Game.
We're booting Demon's Souls. And...
The worst Souls game is Metal Wolf.
No, don't
think
say
about
that.
It.
Spy, it's not very good at being
Everybody
a
shut up. Spy, what
well,
are you in for?
For starters, we talked about this a little bit during your little accidental public test the other day, but this Souls game is... probably the most broken out of all of them, and also the least balanced.
Well, it's coming out of the fucking TV.
yeah, that's supposed to happen. Because if I make
our audio setup is perfect.
Okay, hold on a second.
For us to hear Spy, like we can't hear the game at the same time.
Thank you. Exactly.
But it does power through.
Otherwise, we'd be hearing it on a delay and not able to hear it live.
Oh, okay.
No one else can really hear it though because we have the mics in front.
Okay.
There are many factors.
Now the other issue right now is that
I can't fucking hear.
Okay, you cannot hear Spy.
German Spy. Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, this is great.
Bum me up. So this intro video, I always felt was the best one, and none of the other ones held a candle.
I happen to agree with you on that, Liam, yes.
I don't know if I agree, but it's the most, all the other ones are like story bit or prologue, and this one is just like CG vertical slice.
It's the feel of a Demon's
Souls.
Yeah,
no. Yeah, because this never happens. Like, none of the stuff in this
actually
happens.
Spoilers.
Yeah, no. Well, that part happens, but it's in a different location.
It happens a bit different.
Okay,
these skeletons are the best.
Yeah, because they have the wrong face.
Yeah.
They have a regular face, and then they have an underneath face.
Just give them more jaws, and they'll get cooler.
Well, you're probably going to notice that...
You might say that it's a dead guy made up of many dead guys.
...at several points throughout this game, is that enemies, as they appear in the CG sequences and on the loading screens, are not necessarily going to be quite as they appear in-game. For example, you'll note that Bjor is shown on the loading screens holding a katana, which he does not use.
Yeah. That bit with Bjor always confused me.
It just has to do with changes that were made in development. The loading screens were taken, I guess, at an earlier point before somebody decided, you know what?
Sorry, Spy, I can't hear you.
Everyone stop listening to Spy.
Yeah.
Oh, now I can't listen to anything.
Perfect.
He's a German Spy.
Oh, this is the best stream.
Maybe now we should have tested this
really
with all four people the other day.
This is the best.
The problem we're having...
Testing's no good.
Okay, everyone here, quiet. The problem we're having is the same one that happens with your Sony headphones.
Yeah, it's the headphones, isn't it?
But it's my Sony headphones, too.
We get the same problem.
They're the same Sony headphones.
So the problem is that your headphones don't use the normal extenders. You need a specific type of extender.
I don't know. Yeah. I use the normal extenders in my house, and they work totally fine.
They're perfectly calibrated.
Oh, sick. These... undemonstrable.
Yeah, bone. Technical problems on stream. God. I love it. It's great.
All right. Perfect. Well, here,
check off your bingo cards.
Well, here we go.
Dude,
hold
those
on,
bingo
hold on,
cards
hold on,
are
everybody.
Easy mode.
Yeah. Hold on.
Like, hilarious.
No. Oh.
Did you that's what we wanted.
Oh, yeah.
I am indeed still here. Well, I can hear you guys fine. So is everything working now on your end?
We should just leave the technical difficulties thing on for 6 hours and call it a night.
Oh, dude!
You know what, Liam, we should just play the game and leave the technical difficulty screen on while we're doing commentary.
Let's enjoy it ourselves, right?
Imagine what it's like for us to play Demon's Souls while you stare at the technical... We're not going to cancel the stream.
Yeah.
No, the stream's going to go on ahead.
You just have to picture it in your mind.
Oh, boy. Okay.
Oh, this is good. I like this.
This is perfect.
This is good.
Welcome. Oh, I didn't see you there.
No, you can't. Just start it here. Just start it here.
Oh, hello, American investor. I see you're interested in super best friends for your home prefecture. But please, don't believe us.
Their stock is very rich in nutrients.
So,
what?
Please,
Wooly, you are going to have a choice to make pretty much immediately before you even start the game, which is, do you plan on playing online?
So everybody yesterday in the stream was talking about how this would flow
the
out.
The tendency and stuff?
And there was that, and everyone was talking about what you guys would be telling me to do.
Well,
and I ultimately said I'm going to defer to Spy's judgment. However, from what Plague explained to me, Going online, unless we see a reason not to, is going to be the thing I want.
Going online has cool stuff. The only problem with going online is that it busts a bunch of stupid mechanics.
But that's, yeah, go online. I would say go online.
Also, Slow Beef can't join if you don't play online.
Yeah, of course.
Now, so, if there's a reason that arrives that creates a problem being online,
well,
then we'll switch.
I don't anticipate it, Wooly, but the two things to consider are World Tendency events, as long as you stay online for this entire session and don't log off and then back on again, you'll be fine. Because it's logging out of the servers and logging back in that screws up your World Tendency. Once you're in, you're safe. And
yeah, it won't
correct. And logging in at the very beginning can be beneficial because it will usually push your World Tendencies toward white right off the bat. So you'll get a bonus. It'll make it easier to activate the White Tendency events to start. The problem, and this is going to be probably an unprecedented problem with 6,000 some odd people watching.
Wait, are we up to 6,000
already? We are pretty close to it, if not over,
6,000 people are looking at
Well, that's what, 1% of your YouTube subscriber base, so.
It's
Bazwort.
It's like 1.2%.
Oh, come on, wart.
There we go.
Bazworth?
Bazworth, okay.
So this is the convention we're going with.
I'm just
going
to call him Baz with a silent worth.
Why break the convention at this point?
Hey, Wooly, so you know how the character creators in those games are not very good?
Yeah. This is the original
worstest one by, like, fucking far.
Depending upon your goal, though, because if you're trying to create, if you're treating it like Waifu Maker, yeah, it's the worst one. But if...
Yeah. Well, Baz is our waifu.
If you're trying to create a green-skinned, deformed monstrosity, this is actually a really good character creator.
And it's very robust.
Yes, you just mash random about.
You can deform your character in any way
you
want.
Yes, exactly.
Barbarian.
That seems about what Baz would be.
Spy barbarian.
Well,
the best class,
okay.
Yes.
I feel he's a wanderer.
Some people were telling me to go as royalty,
okay,
and I was like, I don't know what these words
okay,
mean.
Go ahead.
Let me explain.
No, let spy.
Well,
let spy.
I'm not averse to Pat throwing his two cents in. Maybe I'll just wait and correct him afterward.
We
go ahead.
Are.
Royalty is the easy mode one.
Well, not only do you start with magic, but you start with a ring that regenerates your MP, and you start with a weapon that is extremely powerful for parries and riposts. So, yeah, royalty is easy mode. Pretty much anything else is more or less equal.
Every single time I've played the game, I picked knight.
So
okay,
knight,
not
soldier.
No,
so,
knight.
Just regular. Because
he's got the armor of the guy on the bottom.
Correct.
The fluted armor. Yeah.
Wooly, this is going to come down to what I told you before about it's entirely your choice how much you break the experience for yourself.
Magic is for cowards.
Yeah. I'm leaning towards barbarian because I feel like I associate that with the Baz, but also
okay.
Yep.
I feel like, I mean, either one, you can, it's just a starting point like any other Souls game, and then you can go where you
He's
want
kind of
there.
Like
yes,
barbarian
actually,
royalty,
yeah, pretty
the,
much
the neat
it.
Thing about that in this game, Wooly, is that unlike in all of the other Souls games, leveling down is a mechanic, so if you end up with a stat spread you're not happy with, and you feel like putting in the effort, and we've got 6,000 some odd people whom I'm sure would be happy to level you down, and probably will attempt to do so if they run into you online, you can just reset your build to a certain extent. For some reason, though...
That's really annoying to do, though. That takes a while.
It does. It is very annoying, but it can be done. I mean, not...
Yeah.
It's viable.
There's no beards unless they're in details,
there are no beards
in
this game,
though.
Those haven't been a thing for... I don't think until Dark Souls 2.
You're going to make
Dark 2,
very disappointing pass.
Yeah.
Don't worry about it.
But you know what? With what we have to work with, that blonde was not...
Well, you know what my suggestion would be? My suggestion would be to hit random until you get garbage and then work from there.
Yeah, no.
This is fine. This is fine. I like how the front of the hair looks kind of like Pat.
So ultimately, what
looks
you can...
Like
all these settings are just...
More like, looks like Vegeta. He's got too much.
All these...
No, the front. Just the front.
The front.
No, where it balds up like 8 inches.
Where it used to be a widow's peak, and I said I have a widow's peak, I'm not going bald, and then it was like... Then it kept going, and I was like, shut up.
If it's slightly more triangly, it's very Vegeta-esque.
Mm-hmm. So all these settings are for, like, changing the shape, but you can't really add...
Correct,
No. Oh, wait, no, hold on.
Well, no, what that is it's the texture of the skin that this is going to affect.
Oh, yeah,
it's not... It's not a beard model. It's just the skin texture.
We can color your skin.
Yes, that's the lips that I think of when I think of the Baz.
And look, it changes. Every slider changes a different slider when you fucking move it.
Yes, so this is what I meant when I said if you want to make a horrible monstrosity.
It's like he ate someone's ass out.
Oof. Okay. Oh. Why don't you click that default button? Oh, wait, no default button. You're stuck with this.
In the
totally
4-6 hours of waifu.
Not on the facial hair, though. Yeah.
Wow. Okay, I see what you're talking about.
Whenever you're good.
Yeah.
No.
I was just trying to change that mouth dirt into something blonde.
There's no victory here.
But it seems like I can't.
Everything is a massive loss from top to bottom.
Yeah, and I think Pat and Liam can probably vouch for this as well from having spent some time with this character creator.
So yeah. I tried once to make a character, and then I said fuck it and just used the default guy and made his hair like red.
Yeah.
That's it.
Okay.
Because like...
I threw time into it the first time, and it wasn't even worth it. So,
because you have to remember that, like, coming off like all the Kingsfield games, like they're in first person, so they didn't bother with obviously like a physical character creator. So in this one, they're just like, fuck it, who cares?
All right.
Well, this game also feels like super cheap compared to all the ones that came after it.
Well, when you consider the fact that Miyazaki was handed this game partway through development in much the same way that Tanimura was handed Dark Souls 2.
I didn't know that. Mm-hmm.
So
yeah,
he did a better job of it. There's a bit of a funny story behind that, which I'll save for later if anybody's interested. Miyazaki did a hell of a job salvaging this, considering what shape it was in when he got it.
I mean, a lot of From Software games up until post Demon Souls felt kind of low budget. Stuff like the first Lost Kingdoms, for example, is just like
Murakami.
Super low budget feeling. It's crazy
for sure.
Okay, so this will just be like an earlier version of Baz before he grew into
the Baz.
So the rugged man. Yeah.
So this game has a plot dump, and I don't like it.
Right, yeah, I suppose I should shut up then. Enjoy your opening cinematic, Wooly.
I thought it was your favorite game. Why do you not like the plot dump? No sound.
Yeah, I'm turning it up.
Jesus. Oh, man.
See, like, I don't like it because it's kind of a shitty plot dump.
Well, yeah.
I was going to say you could put this in front of any of the Mortal Kombats.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, totally.
Mighty warriors were drawn to the accursed land.
Now can they hear it? Oh, we'll have to wait a little bit because of the Twitch delay.
Yep, seems like they said it's fine.
Bjor is the greatest.
Yurt's the greatest.
No, Yurt. Bjor could kick his ass.
It sounds like
totally, like in 2 seconds. Like there's no chance. I always couldn't believe like how tough Skurver is.
Yeah, considering what he is, yeah.
Like, it's super, super crazy.
NPCs in this game in general are really tough for the most part. Some of the ones around the Nexus go down pretty quick, but...
Thomas?
Just... Well, important ones, though, are...
Hey, you wanna punch, like, Seder and Brain? Like, okay, it takes one second, but, like, look at Bjor wrong and your head is all the way up your ass.
Yeah, he'll bash your face through a wall.
Mm-hmm.
And there's, like... Black Skirver.
Oh, the Black Phantom anything will bash your face through a wall in this game, yeah. We still have to talk to Wooly about that, don't we?
No.
I think let's let him find out first.
Well, I mean about tendencies, so because...
Yeah, well...
God damn it, we should have made Theodore. That line would set up a Trogdor very, very well.
Oh, these are nice.
Yeah, this is the thing I remember.
Yeah.
You have all these little nice loading screens of a bunch of different characters.
It doesn't give you item lore, but this is gorgeous.
And then you go, when am I going to meet that character? And sometimes the answer is never.
Yeah.
Well,
I really hope we manage to make it to
Well, that's, somewhere. Again, going to depend on world tendency. So the other point about world tendency and about playing online, Wooly, is... body form, if you die in body form, it can majorly screw up your world tendency. So,
Spy is apparently.
Am I too loud? I'm always too loud. Everyone tells me that.
No,
not for us, but apparently it's your mix a bit too high.
Matt.
Sure, I don't know what I did. I guess it's existing as I normally do.
Pat has become the stream's bitch.
Yeah, well, that was inevitable.
Is Patrick Fuckboyven.
Oh, God damn it, that's really solid, and it's gonna stick. Fuck.
Yeah.
That's the worst.
I've always admired your fan base for how quickly things become lore. I swear, Grand Wizard Waka was canon within 10 minutes of that video going live.
Yeah, Grand Wizard Waka.
It did that stupid World of Warcraft thing where you start the game and you're inside another character model. Okay. I love that fucking
That's what that
shit.
Was?
Yeah.
Yeah. It looked like it.
Okay, guys, I turned down Spy. Is that still...
Well, just let it go.
I have a feeling
we'll
I'm still
going to
be too loud, because I always am, even when I'm talking alone.
You're definitely lower.
Oh, my God, Liam, you should see how this chat is blowing up, you asshole.
It's blowing up good. It's blowing up the right way.
Oh, this is...
Good job, guys.
This is inescapable. This is every single one.
You know, Pat, I've been lurking in stream for about an hour or so before we started, and there was a straw poll asking what would be the first thing to happen. Some racist comment being made, you coming up with a new catchphrase, and several other things that have already happened. And within 10 minutes of the stream starting.
Well, when the stream couldn't hear us, we said all that racist stuff.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
so. That's why Mr. Snip Snip.
That's when we get it all out.
Well, he's not present.
Oh, your control scheme is like really similar.
Yeah, you can't. Mr. Okay. Snip Snip can't help you out on
Just
Twitch.
Remember, it's not Bloodborne. I'm sure I don't need to tell you that.
Yeah, you might be able to.
So, this is a pretty neat dungeon. And you will have a good time with it. And I'm sure you will be seeing it.
Well, yes, I'm sure. I'm sure he's going to spend a long time here, Liam, isn't he?
A sure long time.
There's no jump in this game.
As in a forward R2 attack? No, there's not.
No jumping attack. But if you run and hit roll, I think you still do the jump.
Don't you do a little leap?
No.
God, I totally.
There's no running and double tapping circle in this game either.
Okay, that's what I thought.
There's no falling attack. There is no. There are no.
You mean
the plunging
attack?
Where you're falling and you press R1.
I'm never gonna let that name go with the best.
The plunging attack.
There we go. That's the thing I see on all the videos. Fucking ragdolling.
Yeah.
Oh God, I haven't
seen ragdolling.
That's why people like loved it when it came back in Bloodborne.
It is in Bloodborne, but it's
not as goofy.
But in Bloodborne, a lot of enemies just dematerialize, so you don't get to do it nearly as much.
Demon Souls, you can end up with just piles of ragdolls. Just roll through them.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, so I see a decent suggestion, which is set your game for Twitch.
Which means what?
Set the Twitch channel to say the right game.
Yeah. Because right now it's like streaming bullshit.
Good point.
I get corrected on that all the fucking time.
Yeah, a good point.
So I saw that you rolled into barrels earlier.
Yeah.
If you roll into barrels too much, you murder the frame rate in some places.
Oh, yeah,
it's great.
Another thing you can do to murder
the frame rate, and there's one particular room in Stonefang.
Play it.
Well,
is
yes,
play normally?
But
yeah.
there are exploding barrels in this game that will blow up.
Yeah.
If you get fire anywhere near them,
and there's one room in particular that's just floor-to-ceiling exploding barrel, you can crash...
Doesn't an enemy throw something at that to make it happen?
There's a fat minister in there who will throw a flame toss at it. If you throw one firebomb in that room, you can crash the game.
Nice.
No, it's pretty sick.
So
we're the 14th largest stream on Twitch.
So we're gonna
14 sounds good.
Rolling is a problem, Liam. You're saying if I
no, it's not actually.
No, it's just the Havoc's physics engine is poorly optimized.
You might notice sometimes that hey, that's the case. And for everyone who played this game before Dark came out, a lot of people, including myself, who like went in blind on day one, had no idea that like items weren't dropped from barrels and boxes.
Yeah, no.
So a lot of like people who went in on day one, like I did, were rolling through and hitting every box trying to find items and stuff.
I was not day one. I was like year two, but I still didn't know.
Right. I'm going to assume that Crescent Moongrass is what I need to.
It's heals.
Yes.
It's my Estus.
Yeah.
Yeah, you just got to chew that shit up.
But it doesn't restore.
That's your life gem.
Exactly. And that's another thing you're going to have to get used to, Wooly, is that not only is Crescent Moon, and there are several other types of it as well, they're your heals. But first of all, they stack to 99. You can carry multiple types at a time. Hurt. And
no, it's not.
Barely. Fall damage and Demon Souls.
Yeah.
Welcome to Demon Souls.
Wooly, DS2 fucked up your perception of the series' fall damage.
You can safely drop from
there. No,
okay,
that's,
sorry,
that's
go on, Spy.
No, you can't. Baz
can. There's even, rather pointlessly, a ring in this game that decreases the fall damage you take even more. So,
yeah. There's very few places where that's actually, like, handy for a regular run. Like, for gimmick things, it's really
yeah,
handy,
it
but.
Really isn't useful in most situations. But as for healing items,
direct also.
You, this system, in or rather, this game is the only game in the Souls series, unless they brought it back in Dark Souls 3, which I sure as hell hope they didn't, but that has a system called Item Burden, which is, you can't carry a certain amount of items beyond your weight limit.
You have a very hard limit on, like, shit to carry.
And then you walk super, super slow.
So you'll get into situations where you'll run into, like, oh, I want to pick up this armor. And then I'll say, nah, bro.
Because
you can't.
Because the armor weighs, like, 50 pounds.
So then you leave, like, two pieces of it on the floor, and you leave, and then it fucking disappears
from
the game forever.
Okay, is backstabbing the same?
Yes, so is parrying.
More or less.
I think it's the most generous
By
in this
far.
Game.
The parrying, I felt like it was the easiest
By
in
far,
deaths
absolutely.
Of any
yes.
game ever.
The parry window
good.
In this game Slide is really wide. Shields, in particular, tend to give you a lot of parry frames. And then there's the parrying dagger, which gives you even more.
See, that's my boy. That dude's the shit.
This guy's your buddy.
I wanted something really random to happen in front of Wooly's eyes. Like, it goes into cyberspace and it turns into, like, Superhuman Samurai Cyber Squad. And we're like, didn't you know, Wooly, about deaths?
The original Demon Souls was Cyber Squad?
It was directed by an Armored Core dev. What did you expect?
Yeah,
that's true.
Yeah, that's why you play like a really, really slow armored core.
Pretty much.
This game did have the hit triangle
to hold your weapon in two hands.
Yeah, totally.
Yes.
Dual hand. Yeah.
Yeah.
Now.
Yeah.
So probably the thing me and Spy were talking about this the other day, Wooly. And
bonfire.
No.
Not bonfire.
No. Doesn't exist yet. Okay. New mechanic that comes later. Okay. But me and Spy were talking on Skype the other day, and we're talking about how. When we went back to Demon Souls after playing a bunch of Dark Souls 1, like, this game is, like, super easy in comparison.
It's easy, and it's like, the polish is not there.
No.
And the jank is high.
No. But it's still your favorite because it's, like, so fucking new, right?
Because, like, playing it without knowing.
Yeah.
Just going in
when it's
relatively
this brand
blind.
New, totally fucking weird thing.
Yeah. It was a hell of, and I've told you before, but when I played it, I had a roommate and we had our TVs set up right next to each other and we played co-op
That's
through the entire game next to each other. It was
Hello,
almost split
friend.
Screen.
What are you
Good
about?
Luck, Wooly.
I love these fucking guys.
Read those messages,
it's such it's such a fucking just like fuck you, that's for real.
Yeah.
And the sad thing is, this guy's AI.
Yeah!
This guy's AI is toned down from the ones you run into later.
Sick.
Yeah. Oh, don't tell him that.
Yeah. No, but the
nothing good.
So, right. Wooly, you felt it right there. Like, you're used to DS2's shitty fucking parrying. Like, the DS and DS1 parrying was way easier and way more viable.
Let me just see what was up.
Hey,
nothing.
Spy,
you can't
you played
go up those
a bunch
stairs.
Of Dark Souls 3,
yes,
right?
I participated in the
blocked.
Network test, which
what is the parrying feel?
Parrying is almost like
this area is pretty much straight. Yeah. So
okay, I'm going to need to just like get my bearings and look though. So
no, sure. I
you by all means really take your time and explore. Pat, parrying in Dark Souls 3, and remember this is just the NT, it could change, but it's almost exactly Demon Souls Dark Souls 1.
Oh my god, yeah.
And
that
seems
to
be a central theme of Dark Souls 3, where they've essentially said, well, we tried Dark Souls 2, we tried Bloodborne, people didn't really seem to like those quite so much, so screw it, we'll just go back to what everyone loved more than anything, which was clearly Dark Souls 1.
And demons,
to a certain extent.
I think the parrying in Bloodborne was fun in its own way.
Well, yeah,
totally.
It was different.
But like, Yeah, Liam, what you were saying before, like, I think Dark Souls 1 is, like, a way better game. It feels like a complete version of this, but it was a sequel, and that by itself, like, takes some of it and, like, makes it slightly less rad.
Yeah.
Because the concepts were similar.
No, exactly. And it was also, for most of the game, it was thematically similar as well. Mm-hmm. It wasn't like Bloodborne, where it was a big departure from knights to, like, werewolves and then great ones. It was knights to knights.
Mm-hmm.
And that was it.
Not
to say
fire.
It's not a great
item
game.
Item description is a thing where like, I can pull up.
Yeah,
can,
totally. Hit square.
Okay. Square. There we go. Okay. Remnants of an old hero's soul drifting partially into another world.
Pat, that being said about parries in Dark Souls 3, though, backstabs are very different.
Good. What do? They change the cone.
Well, no,
so
there's a delay. When you get behind somebody and you hit R1 to initiate a backstab, it doesn't immediately lock them into the backstab animation. What you do is you essentially initiate a regular physical attack that will drag them into the backstab animation if it connects.
Okay. So is it faster than DS2's backstab
animation? Yeah, it's fast enough so that really what it does is prevent lag stabs, or to mitigate them anyway. Yeah,
okay,
and actually I'm impressed with the solution they came up with for that, because from my experience in the NT, it does seem to work.
You had all that time.
Yeah.
Fog door
but
already.
Wasn't sure.
Huh.
Hey Wooly, pick up the stuff off those dead guys.
No jumping.
No jumping.
No jumping. No. Yeah. The only thing you can do is roll.
So, heads up, there is a boss coming up.
No, don't spoil that.
No. I'm not going to tell him anything about it.
Yeah,
but I just want to advise you, if you can get behind him, there's an Uchigatana, which is a strong katana back there. If you can get behind him.
Is that how
Uchigatana.
It's pronounced?
Uchigatana, what a...
Uchigatana?
Uchigatana.
Nox Nognaba.
And the Gangabangana, too.
It is an Uchigatana, right?
It's either a Uchigatana or a Northern Regalia, Liam. Something like that, yes.
That item was in one of the.
There's no way it's the Northern Regalia. That's crazy. Like, there's no way.
So, the other thing about online mode in this game, Wooly, is that invasions can only happen when you're in body form.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, this is certainly a fucking...
And they're also, like, way more common than you're probably used to.
They're also way more common when you have 6,000 people looking for a chance to stream snipe.
Yeah.
Oh, and they're like, hey, I'm gonna hop on Destiny
and
blow you up.
So, the other part of that...
This guy's a lot like the first demon you fight in Dark Souls,
yes.
Right?
Very similar,
He's got those big, like... He's basically Samoa Joe.
So can we get the bingo card, which is 5 hits on boss? That's 2, right?
Something like that, yeah.
There's a big Bowser, like, Smash Brothers
attack. This whole area, Matt, really is the same concept
as 3.
The Northern Asylum in Dark Souls.
Alright, Phil, your bingo card, that's 5 hits on boss. Good job, Wooly.
You're doing it.
So my favorite thing about this boss is that he is beatable.
Yeah.
And I thought he wasn't when I first fought him.
A lot of people think he wasn't.
And fighting and watching Wooly fight him now, I am like, oh my god, he is a fucking joke! Compared to some of the bosses we have fought.
If this is your first boss in a Souls game, you will die.
Oh yeah, no,
there is no way you will survive.
I got my ass severely ruined.
Yeah.
But like, I'm thinking of, like, say, Forge Demon.
Smelter.
Yeah.
Yes.
Smelter Demon, rather. Smelter Demon.
This is actually forgiving because it shows you where the butt stomp ranges.
Well, yeah,
and you can see it clearly.
Are almost always the ones who try fighting him from the front.
You can clearly see the size of the ass.
Yeah, no. In this little tail butt. There's also an art style change that the Souls games went through away from demons that I actually prefer in Des, where this demon looks like kind of grosser than the stuff you would see in Dark Souls. Like, not like Gaping Dragon, sure, but just like more grotesque.
Yeah, a lot. A handful of Demon Souls bosses and areas are definitely a bit more grotesque than the content in Demons. Dark, excuse me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, Dark felt very, like,
generic knights.
No, not. It's a difference of opinion, because I would say, like, classic.
Yeah, no, they're not. Sorry, they're not generic. That was a,
like,
that was a stab
it,
at
it.
It
wanted
but...
to go classic, whereas this game wanted to go really weird. Like, I love the how far back his wings come out of his back. Oh, so the stream just broke. Like,
no, it just my computer going into.
Yeah, no, the stream is fine on my end.
I'll probably turn that off.
Okay, well.
Another thing that sometimes happens is Twitch will get wonky, and that doesn't mean the stream itself is freaking out.
No, it's actually his screensaver on his computer.
Yeah, no, we were seeing his nice screensaver of like a colorful city life.
Wolf Among Us.
Oh, it's Wolf. Yeah, it's
yeah.
Wolf
he's
Among
had Wolf Among Us as his wallpaper for
like four
ever
years.
Since it was announced.
Because like it looks fucking amazing that game.
Man, Wooly's doing it.
You're doing
unless
it.
You make like thousands.
Whoa,
of
that
I'm really impressed.
I'm really impressed at how well you're
indeed.
Doing it.
I stand by what I said before, which is when you come to this guy after having played other Souls games, you can totally
exactly.
do it.
Like, even if he doesn't win, which he
oh,
doesn't.
Well.
Yeah.
Oh,
shit. Even if he doesn't, like, that's way better than I did when I tried it the first time.
Yeah, of course, definitely.
Man, you died against that Vanguard princess.
So the massive bummer about that is that if you do beat him, you get a bunch
yeah,
of
yeah, you also get a very cool cutscene.
Yeah, you get it. You get the coolest
yeah.
cutscene.
Look at this King of Fighters character.
Oh my god, that's awesome. Yeah. Okay. Fuck. I gotta. Yeah. Let me just try to fix this desktop.
Fix the
thing.
Stream, dipshit.
Shit.
Oh, I love this. I love having no responsibility in this situation.
It's pretty good.
It's, great.
It's really good.
Damn, I could have done that.
Yeah.
So,
no.
Wooly,
yeah.
in connection
it.
With the online mode thing, another choice you're going to have to make is whether or not you restore yourself to body form because. You are going to die. Dying
no.
in body form will affect your world tendency in whatever area you die in. And
yep.
it is entirely likely, and in fact a guarantee, that if you walk around in body form, somebody from the stream chat will invade you with a scraping spear and acid cloud and break all your shit. And
because that's the best combination in the game.
Yeah, totally.
And unlike
I see.
In the later
yeah.
Souls games, acid cloud actually does something in deaths.
Yeah, Acid Cloud's mm-hmm. badass. In
so,
I want to see a comeback to that in DS3 where there's like game ruining PvP abilities.
Yeah, they're sick.
I want to have the ability to steal items off of characters.
That'd be awesome. People really hate them, but that'd be awesome.
Yeah. And it's super hard to hit. It's like a soul sucker.
Yeah.
You know?
So the other thing about being dead in this game is you have 50% of your maximum
But there is
life.
A workaround
yeah.
for that.
So I'm now being sent to the Nexus.
Yep. Yes.
That's correct.
It's usually the place where fighting game crossovers happen.
Mm. Yeah, the Nexus is also the place in Heroes of the Storm. It's
yeah.
where you're gonna find Jimmy Rayner here.
It's your generic term for your husband.
Okay,
sorry.
Give me something.
Let me just try to see what.
You gotta fix his wallpaper.
Okay, guys, stall for time.
No, I just.
So while we do have German Spy here, and he is a fairly reliable source for all Souls information, just in case of issue, we all are equipped with a Demon Souls strategy guide. And I don't think anything will be able to stop us armed with three of them.
I don't need this because I know everything. No.
We have three times the amount of knowledge that we normally
actually,
have.
Actually, no, seriously, like this is really useful, but for death strategy, like there's like three things you actually have to know.
Yeah.
And it's where the Crescent Falchion is, where the Purple Shield is, and that's it. That's all you need.
Well, and where to get... like materials, like late game materials, but
well,
we're not doing that shit. So
that
not doing
being
that
said,
shit.
Though, we aren't just going to let the Crescent Falchion carry us the whole game, are we?
Oh yeah, no, it's the only way.
Yeah, without
it's,
a doubt,
it's the stream way. Oh man, the Crescent Falchion
very
is so
well,
fucking good.
I leave that choice up to Wooly.
Like the Drake Sword in Dark Souls 1 is really good, but Crescent Falchion is good enough to do the whole game.
No,
no
I
want to
use the Bone Crusher.
You mean Dragon Bone Smasher?
Smasher, yes,
yeah.
Thank you.
No, you mean the Black Man.
Because the build I
yeah,
went
no,
with
the Black Man.
The build I have on my character
yeah.
is that weapon, the Tower Shield, and yeah. full Breor armor.
That is
that's my build.
I like your
best.
Really close to the build I went.
Thank you.
That's very, very close to the build I went with the last time I played, and I ended up getting a huge amount of souls and body form and all that shit from playing 3-2
mm-hmm.
and I would get the two-handed smasher and just go invade people
oh,
up on the
yeah.
catwalks and
and kick them off.
You don't need to kill them, you barely need to hit them.
Yeah,
so what did I get, what do I get if I had beaten that guy?
What
cool oh
shit.
You get cool,
you get
shit and a cool cutscene,
stones, some higher tier healing grass, and I think a couple of soul items. So it's
yeah.
it's not game breaking. Really the main reason for beating him is to get the cutscene.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Wow, this is super cool.
It's
yeah.
gorgeous, actually.
So it's
yeah.
probably worth taking just a moment to familiarize yourself with this area, Wooly, because you're going to be coming back
yeah.
here a lot.
Yeah, and so the best part is that if you attack an NPC in this game, they don't aggro you.
Mm-hmm. You're going to want to go up the stairs. Oh, wait, not yet. He doesn't want to go up the stairs yet, does he?
I don't want to trigger anything. I just want to look at things right now.
Yeah. Are we going to roll with that?
There's no point in going up the stairs yet. So.
Okay.
Like, if you go and attack Stockpile Thomas right now, like, he'll never attack you back.
Who's that?
Stockpile
who's that?
Thomas.
Yeah. Who's
Read this info. Bam. Hmm. Best of luck to you.
All right. How do I rate that?
You don't. Okay. It's not a real message.
Oh, it's an offline message.
Yeah. It's a fake.
So Stockpile Thomas.
Okay, wait, no, Wooly, okay. Don't actually attack these NPCs.
I feel obligated to remind you, Pat, that I promised Wooly I would be a good wingman.
Yeah.
All right. Because we're all bad ones. All right.
Now
I don't know if you guys promised him or not.
Yeah, of course. Press buttons.
I want to familiarize myself with this menu setup because this is all super different.
Pat's
to
trying to get Wooly to attack
and it's
NPCs
all like super old looking.
It's actually relatively similar to the
That's
ones
like
you're used
the
to.
Coins in Bloodborne.
The coins?
Throwing the coins.
The coins.
Oh yeah, yeah. Or the
it
light
attracts
things.
Attention.
It's just
a marker. You'll never use them.
There's only one location in the entire game where it's kind of useful.
That's true.
And even then, like, it's not that.
It's almost
they're,
a waste
they're
of time.
They're decorative. Usually, people just use better. Them for drawing penises on the ground. So,
yeah, they're really good for screenshots.
They're really good for making a big penis.
Add to user soul stock.
Yeah, it gives you souls.
Everything that says souls,
it's the blood stuff.
Except for soul remains. Soul remains is the one that you throw.
And boy, is
it
broken!
I don't think I've ever used
soul remains. Oh yes,
is it?
Pretty nearly every enemy type responds to it, and you can just make enemies walk off cliffs with it and other broken crap like that.
Mm-hmm. So it depresses them.
Do I need to equip that next?
No, that's your dark
binding.
Yeah.
That'll bring you back to the Nexus and lose all your shit.
I'm Stockpile Thomas.
Stockpile Thomas is the fucking shit. No, he's the shit.
I'm not saying he's not. In the Nexus,
my wife and daughter fell victim to the demons. But I would be worthless in battle.
I love how he's shit. Least,
he knows he's shit. But he managed to amass all these riches.
Well, they're not his. He's just holding on to them for people. Look after any quote unquote.
That's true.
Holding on to them.
Oh, okay. So you're just a little treasure
chest.
Well,
he's not yeah, and the reason he exists is because there is the inventory system that has weight in this game.
You need to dump stuff here.
Yeah.
You need to dump tons of shit into Thomas.
And Wooly,
only heroes abandon their wives and daughters.
A further piece of advice I would give you, Wooly, is that if you have to put the controller down anywhere in the Nexus, open the menu.
I wish I could do more. Or and do it very far away from the NPC.
Because there is no pardoner NPC in this game, so if you aggro somebody, that's it. You're done.
They're done for the game.
Fingers off the trigger. Trigger discipline.
So like if you hit the Maiden in Black and aggro her, you've lost the ability to level up forever.
I see.
If you hit Thomas, you lose the ability to do anything with your items.
Harsh, well, okay. But
Pat,
fair.
No, it's super
Pat,
not fair
actually,
at all.
Harsh, the Maiden in Black is the one NPC.
The Maiden doesn't have that effect. Yeah.
Go, doesn't? As no. a matter of fact.
Okay.
Yes.
Can't you kill her?
Yes, and she'll come back.
What?
I don't know shit.
Did you hear?
Put that on the bingo card.
Okay. Stop. So that guy said when the Scourge came.
The demon.
Is the Scourge, the curse, slash...
No, there's no curse.
The demons. What's... Just bring me
all it's the nebulous demons bad
but,
guys.
But
yeah.
I mean, it's the thing in this game that is the problem that invaded
the
world.
Yeah.
That's what I mean. It's not literally the curse.
The
I mean,
the problem
like,
is the mist.
Yeah, and the mist. Everywhere the mist goes, demons start showing up. So yeah, the Scourge is all of that.
Yeah, and they eat souls. Mm-hmm. It's way simpler than the other games in terms of like backstory, where it's the Kingdom of Boletaria found this new magic, mm-hmm. and then all of a sudden everything went really fucking bad.
Mm-hmm. Why? By the way, you see up there your item
it
burden.
It went bad.
Right now, since you don't have a suit of armor, you're really
you're
light. You've got very little on you. The shield and the club is really all you got.
Yeah.
As far as weight goes.
You got little
but
pants.
Picking up a suit of armor, I believe it'll be at least 30 to 40 pounds, if I'm not
Depending.
Mistaken.
Yeah, that's right.
But I don't
lighter.
Recall specifically. Clothing's very light, mm-hmm. yeah.
Okay.
And this guy will sell your basic... he sells all the starter
Some.
Weapons, right?
The rest you can pick up in the first
Some of them.
Area.
Yeah.
Battle okay. axe sounds cool.
I think you get that in the first area.
Do I have the ability to...
Press square on it. It'll show you what stats it requires.
Yeah.
You need 11 strength. Check out those awesome fucking descriptors. See that weird tentacle thing? That's strength.
Yeah. Those...
That those, screams.
Those icons are actually its damage type. Those little horizontal and vertical slash lines right under the name. Those are attack type. And then the all the other, like, they handle this with really weird icons. It's not
super
intuitive.
Shitty. I hate it. I hate it so much.
Wow. All right. Now, what are my stats?
Well, you can just go into your
I know.
Your dude.
So another couple of things system-wise, Wooly, that are different in Demon's Souls is that in this game, holding a weapon in both hands gives you effectively 50% more strength. So you can
you can wield a lot of stuff you wouldn't otherwise be able to.
Yeah, you can wield the axe, I think.
Yeah, your strength is 15. Yeah. You'd have no problem. But you can't buy it because you ain't got shit.
Right. And my life is at half right now because
that's
I'm dead.
That's also your limit.
But if Wooly kills an NPC, can he get money?
No.
Wooly, I advise you to kill an NPC.
You'll pick up whatever...
I'll note that.
Okay, good.
You'll pick up whatever specialty item they would drop.
But none of them are worth killing. But
there's
another
blacksmith at the end. Yeah, is there? I'd imagine there must be one.
I can think of two that are worth killing.
I can think of more than two.
As far as the extended cast?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Sure.
Yeah, no, I get...
Yeah.
You know.
No, I meant these guys, but you're right. In the extended cast?
These guys are chumps. Yeah. These guys have nothing of value.
But they're useful chumps.
Mm. Okay. Gotcha. All right.
So, yeah. Well, sure, I forgot this guy triggered a little scene. Did you?
You came for Demon Souls? Oh, hey.
Embarrassing.
How about you square people?
Oh, god damn it. That's the worst. That was a text message calling me a fuckboy.
Thanks. How about you turn that off? Try one of
the Archstones. Who could that be from? Now go.
Ugh. That is why you came. Everything's the worst. To this accursed proletariat.
This is kind of like
I hate the proletariat.
So if you just look here, Will, you see that stone to your left and how they go up and just pan the camera up and all those stones are the worlds that
that's your levels.
Oh, okay.
So
there's
six of them.
So this is more like Bloodborne than the other than DS2 then.
Up to a certain point, because Bloodborne still has a for the most part contiguous world, whereas here each archstone is warping you to a completely different part of the world. Like,
you can't travel from one area to the other without coming to a nexus.
That's what I was gonna ask.
It made me super, super upset when I first started playing this game and I went to Stonefang Tunnel and I was trying super hard to spin the camera to see the other locations.
And I was like,
no, maybe that's really far. And it's like, no.
There's no use going up the stairs right now. There's nothing. You will have to, but it's empty right now.
All right, someone ran up there and died.
Yeah, no. So
you can fall. And
so
there
you go.
The Nexus is filled with dead people all the time. And the reason why is because most people come back and kill themselves right away.
Mm-hmm. This is one.
Because,
this is the like first area.
Because if you die in body form in a location, the world tendency goes closer to black.
Mm-hmm.
So what people do is they go to the Nexus and kill themselves so that they can't lose world tendency.
Sorry, I was reading this whole thing.
Okay. Oh.
Like, there's a lot for me process. I'm sorry. Just give me a minute. Yeah, okay.
By committing suicide repeatedly in the Nexus, you force your world tendency to the worst, and it can't change from there.
What type of dragons are we going to encounter here? Seem like they're going to be terrible.
A bunch.
They're pretty terrible.
I actually really like the dragon in this stage, like the
best. Patches. Yeah. Patches is the best and coolest.
I think Calamite's the only one that I like better.
You guys always talk shit about Patches. Yeah,
you
cool.
Remember him?
Yeah.
He's a shit.
He's a cool spider guy that constantly hustles everyone.
You can't see his face in this.
He's
shot.
The only game he's not in is in DS2, and I really hope he's back in DS3 so that Patches becomes the Miyazaki stamp.
Can't see the spider body that he's hiding.
Well, he does. No, he did. That's Bloodborne.
No, I know. Yeah.
He's the Totoro.
Is this supposed to be like From Software's new mascot? Is that what you're proposing?
Yeah, he is the From Software what Jack Frost is to Atlas, right?
Totally.
Apparently, you're super loud. You'll just turn yourself down a little bit.
I can't reach.
Okay.
I literally like.
All right, that's fine.
Put the work in. Wooly's got to play.
This one is your number two. No, no, you're the red one.
This one?
No, not that one. At the top.
No, your mic feed, not your headphone volume.
Well, never mind.
No, it's too late now. You want me to fucking do it? I'll fucking do it.
So this is the dragon. Any bets whether you think you're going to fight him or not?
No.
No, okay.
Probably
Matt,
not.
Got one for
I think he's going to be my friend.
Okay, well, Good luck with that.
I hope that is better.
Beware the enemies.
I remember this area as like the first area Pat warped into. He's like, look at this fucking shit.
Oh, you played this?
How hard this is. Well, for the Machinima video, that's the last time I looked at it. Oh, well, I looked at Liam play for a little bit, like a few years after that.
Yeah, what we played that? We played it like for I baby time.
Head over there.
Yeah, that's me.
Bam. Get that thing. Yeah. Roll through the thing. You can break all these things with rolling, by the way.
Oh, I'm stuck. I can't get in my comfy position because
people are saying Pat's even louder now.
So I'm sure you already figured it out, Wooly, but down on the D-pad is to switch items, and left and right are for left, right hand,
I read the tutorial. What
people are saying Pat's
faster?
Even louder now.
What?
Great.
How? Great. I turned myself down.
Okay, so this would be what leads me back to the next.
The little sword stuck in the stone. Yes. So,
yeah, okay. This fucking berserk area.
Now Matt's loud.
I didn't. What?
Matt, why are you so loud?
I didn't even say anything.
Idiot.
Wow, Half-Life is going to be a little tricky.
It's a little limited, isn't
it? Rock with.
Fortunately, you get lots of healing items in this area.
You get tons.
They're extremely generous in this particular area.
I bet that guy also has another healing
item.
And
if you ever feel the need to grind out...
three.
Everyone's saying it's fine. All the levels are fine.
Okay, good.
If you see one... Sorry, Liam. If you see one guy say is loud, you have to make sure, like, at least...
No. I don't respond to anything unless it's, like, a couple people. Okay. For sure.
If you ever feel the need to grind, this fucking message. Yeah.
That's
the message.
Where this comes from.
That's where that comes
Enter
from.
The world of survival horror.
So
that's
forget
that
whole first area and the boss that should massacre you. But anyway, if you ever feel the need to grind, just come back here and you can get Crescent Moongrass very quickly. It's not the best healing item, but it's gonna be the best for you for a long time.
You can get tons of it.
Yeah.
Like, that's why it's good.
Yeah. Liam's too loud now, apparently.
Yeah, Liam.
Are you serious?
No.
Are you serious?
It seems like everyone's just
people do seem to be
trolling,
yes.
Why are you so loud, Liam? Man, I was watching like the finale of Nuzlocke stuff that Wooly had running before. Dude, you looked like a completely fucking different person like 2 years ago.
I don't know. I'll probably change it this week too.
It's
so
fucking weird.
Was that 2 years ago already?
Look,
now
you see that ragdoll shit?
Was that 2 years ago already that you guys did that, the Nuzlocke run?
I don't know.
2014.
I just made that up.
2014. Wow. Though Wooly's right. Although technically, like we are like. Bottom end of January.
Yeah, we did it in August of 2014.
Okay, so there's a little bit of illusion on the dates.
So that's like 1 year ago?
Yeah, one and change.
I was finishing a Super Friends episode, so I had to bounce to finish it in time. Because it was going up that day.
Mm-hmm.
And that was in August, so...
Man, I feel embarrassed by my earlier life self watching this footage. Like, Des was so much easier than I thought it
because
was.
Because it was your first Souls game.
Yeah.
Exactly. Like, that's exactly what it is.
I still remember people saying, like, nah, man, Des is still harder. Like, are you fucking crazy?
No. There are certain specific chunks that are just as difficult as you'd expect from a Souls game, but on the whole, it's far easier.
I will say for how old this is, it looks really good.
I was going to say that, too.
It held up very well.
It looks quite impressive.
Definitely.
I expected a lot worse.
Oh, to answer your question as to how do you write a message, it's just select in this game.
Also,
asshole.
Because we're talking about graphics, this is one of the better looking areas. They kind of did front load it a little bit.
There's a poopy area.
Areas like the caves are really ugly, and you know there's places that are not.
The textures
are
pretty basic in underground areas. Sure.
The area that has all the poop in
it looks
like poop.
Yeah, poop zone.
Poop zone
1-3.
Poop zone and spaghetti zone.
That's the one that comes after Green Hill and before Scrap.
They share a lot of textures.
Poop zone 2 is the worst.
Poop zone
2
is the worst.
And pullout zone? Oof.
Yeah.
Oof.
But you're the pullout king.
No, actually the zone after poop zone is should have pulled out zone.
Should have pulled out zone. Just baby zone.
Yeah. Yeah.
Fetus of God.
Yeah. Yeah, actually.
That's really thematically on point.
Yes.
There you go.
Good job.
Quick, Wooly. Jump down there.
That looks like some kind of teleporty place.
Power up.
Yes, it sure does.
Power up.
Will it teleport me to death?
It's up to you.
Sure seems like not a bad place to be.
You're crazy. Poop Zone 1 isn't the worst. Poop Zone 2 is
way worse. Are we playing this way, Pat? Would you like me to just sit back and let you guide Wooly off a cliff to his death when that's the case? Because...
No, Sigh. I expect you to stop
Okay, well...
Sigh. Well, it's up to Wooly to parse out our voices and only focus on spies.
Well, I ask that because my...
Woo!
when they do that combo where they just start swinging wildly, it's
the combo that that enemy type has in every single Souls game.
It's a Canadian combo.
Well, I was just saying that my purpose here isn't to carry Wooly, but just to sort of walk beside him and help him back to his feet should he stumble. But when there are 3 feet sticking out to trip him, you know.
Oh, dude, they're not just sticking out, we're kicking.
Yeah, no, they're actively trying to ruin this, there's a complete difference.
Well, this whole thing is your idea, so the worse we can tank it,
hold that shield up. Yeah, there you go.
In that case...
Backstabs are finicky. Like, you have to be, like...
Look at everything going crazy.
You need to be, like, right behind them.
Okay.
Dark Souls 1 has, like, a crazy wide window on the backstab, like, it's absurd. And DS2 has that bullshit delay, and Bloodborne has the charge-up thing.
Shit, what was that?
Yeah, I was gonna say, quick.
It's never been as good as it was in Dark Souls 1.
As a weird metric, because right now I'm watching, like, Slow Beef play Dark Souls here and there. I think he just recently beat it, and he's playing Dark Souls 2 again now. And he's still finishing Bloodborne, and when he's playing Bloodborne, he's laughing, he's making jokes, he's talking about stuff. And when I tune into him watching playing Demon's Souls, there's a lot of sighing. And I'm not exactly sure why.
There's some bullshit in this game. I would say out of all the games, this one has the most amount of, like, fuck you, that's bullshit.
Where you could not see that coming and you're just...
The area he was in.
Yeah!
The area that he was in specifically was a place where all these manta rays were flying outside and shooting all these fucking electric needles in his ass.
That area is fantastic. One of the most, like, one of my favorite bosses in the Souls series.
Straight up, that boss fight is the coolest looking thing in the entire series.
Yeah.
And it's the only boss fight that uses that mechanic.
Because it's, like, it's a set piece.
There were a lot of fights like that in this game as well. Where
someone's coming down the stairs.
Well, the
probably.
Stompy Stompies.
I don't remember what number. The Tower Knight, whatever. He's fucking incredible,
pretty cool.
Too.
But then there's, 3-3, Liam, that boss, the online
one. What does that noise
Hang
mean?
Hang on, let me open my strategy guide because it's been too long.
When I hear that, like, wah, what does that mean?
Wah?
You got souls?
I believe that is
It's like a reflection kind of
noise.
Oh,
that's the soul noise.
Okay.
What's your question, Liam? I can probably answer
it. Yeah, okay, no, 3-3 is my favorite, you're right.
No, that's the boss fight I'm talking about.
Yeah, that one's amazing.
No, I'm talking about 4-3. I'm talking about 4-3.
No, I don't need any torch or anything.
There's so many
like
good
that, right?
bosses.
Not really.
No, there's no torch item.
Okay, I'm just going to keep glowing no matter where
that's
I am.
What
you have. It's actually the thing that you can see physically on your waist glowing. That's an item.
Your Aug Eye of Souls, yeah, that's what that thing is for.
It's Baz's inner glow.
I have never, ever gotten any cool variant of 3-3.
No?
Like, I've always fought the shitty version.
Well,
no benefit to this besides dex scaling?
Yeah. Also, why do you have two clubs?
You don't need it.
Equipped.
You're better off with both hands.
If he needs to...
Well, no, it's not.
If he needs to twin club it.
If he needs to... it's a viable strategy.
Oh my god, that's a viable strategy.
I don't know if twin clubs are viable in this game. Dual katanas are a famous build in this game, but...
Yeah, okay. Everybody wants to play with their dual katanas because everybody read Forgotten Realms drizzes.
It's not even because of that. It's because dual katanas in Demon's Souls specifically is actually a really kind of broken build.
It's a very good build.
Because shoves in this game work in a completely different way.
And nice block. You know what? I shouldn't fucking talk because when I was playing Baldur's Gate 2 and Drizzt showed up, I totally marked out.
It's forward and R1
correct.
To shove,
and
right?
Each shove.
And it's
it depends
fast.
On the weapon. Shoves with a huge weapon like a greatsword or the DBS, they take forever. They're worthless.
I miss the kick.
So you can shove enemies off platforms
that
with that,
up there.
And it's somewhat viable.
I saw that fucker up there.
Yeah.
I see you.
Yeah, you should.
Hey, Spy, is kick back in DS3?
Yes.
I sure hope it is.
Yeah, the shove does seem to be a lot more like Demons and Dark 1 in DS3.
Yes.
Kick back.
No, it's great, man.
It lost its usefulness completely.
In Dark 2, you mean?
Like, that video of that guy,
pretty much.
That guy, that dude kicked...
Not 100%, but
kicking a hacker off
Smash
the edge
it.
Of the Crystal Caves.
No, you gotta come from above.
Okay. And that fucker's still up there.
Oh, yeah. No, you'll get him, don't worry.
Some bitch.
Man, he's doing so much better than I did.
Gotta chew up all this fucking weed.
Yeah, seriously.
I mean, to be fair, they went for a different sort of guard break mechanic in Dark Souls 2, so they had to change the kicks a little bit.
I really like that guard break mechanic, and it's a shame that it's so hard to do.
So Wooly, now that you've killed that guy, you can actually look. We'll kill that guy, and then you can actually look around and see more of the area off the side. But you should kill that guy first.
Yeah, because that guy's a bitch.
Yeah, and yeah, blocking those fire bombs, you will take some damage.
Yeah, because your shield is poop.
Yes.
But yeah, if you peer over, you can see, like, there's where you started.
That's where I came from.
Yeah, exactly.
The dragon that was flying.
You started at the bottom.
Dragon. He's peaced out.
So that area up there, just pan the camera back up to it, bit to the left, there is a boss in there that we're not going to fight.
Ever.
Straight up, we're not going to fight him. Old King Duran, we're just not going to be able to fight him. You won't be able to get in there.
Why is that?
I don't think you'll do the events correctly.
Okay.
It's not straightforward.
Isn't there an easier one? Easier way? Can't you just kill some guy?
Yes, and that would have been my bet, that he just ends up getting killed on his own before he gets found.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's usually what happens.
That would be the chance, I guess. It's true.
Both times I beat the game, I he totally survived and I got the
thing. And actually, Liam, it's entirely possible to beat him early in the game. Well, not early, but once you get the Storm Ruler.
Can't get to that?
No.
Okay.
Is it? Yeah, I must be misremembering then. Because I remember him.
There you go!
I was waiting for this.
See, now you can.
That was on multiple bingo cards.
Yeah.
That specific moment was on multiple bingo cards.
You were super close to clearing it, though.
And those guys are drunk now.
Yes.
Awesome. So, Liam, the trick with the Storm Ruler is that you you use it to knock him off the edge of the battlement. Because it won't do enough damage to him to make him genuinely hate you and two-hand his weapon and go full-on I'm-gonna-kill-you mode.
But you can still kill him with
and
it.
And when you slap him outside of his leash range, he'll just turn around and start walking back and he'll stop attacking you altogether.
Yeah.
Have you guys
That
ever,
makes a lot of sense. I was saying it more in the regard of I don't think he's going to fill the conditions to get there.
Have you guys ever fought him legit? Because I always cheated.
I fought him legit. But, you know,
I cheated both times.
He's all right. He's not that special.
It's so much easier to just like cheat his leash range and backstab him.
So this game I think has the most evident curving arrows.
Oh yeah, they turn to follow
you.
Yeah,
they're wanted.
Interesting.
They lock on. It's fucking bullshit.
They can curve the bullet arrows.
If you strafe sideways, like if you kill the spearman and then strafe sideways with your shield up, you'll see what we're talking about with the
quick Wooly. Fuck the code.
To everybody chat asking if we're going to use the 200 arrow method to kill the dragon on the bridge, I don't think we're going to have enough arrows or projectiles in general by the time we get there.
What? The 200 arrow method.
Personally,
that sounds ridiculous.
I would really like if we used the 200 arrow method.
Well, the biggest
actually, because I want Wooly to experience that.
That sounds dumb.
You have to have the stats to run it to get like a decent bow to do
it. You can't break those.
Okay. Oh, and you didn't keep.
No, I want to. I didn't see what's this way.
Okay, just making
that's
sure.
That's fair.
But you can buy that many arrows. So.
Yeah, I bought those arrows.
I'm gonna leave that up to Wooly, but. 200 arrows
Absolutely.
Is a little while.
It is.
You get the compound short bow and that'll do it, right? Like, that'll do it no problem. So this is a much stronger version of the one.
Well, there's a crossbow down below here as well you can get that might be a little cheaper.
There is, yeah.
Ooh, backup, yeah.
Yeah. Wooly, this is a pro tip.
But aren't
mashing parry is like the worst thing in the world.
Okay. Yeah.
Does it take a lot of stamina? Doesn't it?
It takes stamina, but also, like, it doesn't work.
That's good.
This guy's, like, his damage output's way lower than I remember.
Yeah, I remember him beasting my ass off. Like...
First Souls game.
Yeah, could be totally. One of the ones later, or just this guy specifically.
Oh! I love that shit.
Get in there.
Stop being such a massive coward.
I can eat the grass, too.
So you can use the shove to push his shield.
I just realized that.
Yeah.
I should mention, Wooly, that he does, like, significant damage through your shield.
Yeah.
Which, like, because your shield sucks.
Yeah, good.
That was solid. That was fucking dope.
Even the greatest warrior with the best armor cannot defend.
That costs too much grass.
Against a shove.
No, it's fine.
Ed's grindstone restores the stamina of your weapon currently equipped.
Welcome to the D&D world.
You're demon soulsing it.
Well done, Wooly.
Where's my duration?
Your durability?
Durability, sorry.
Go to your weapons.
Your equipment.
Yeah, dude, you have two... Oh, no, okay, you don't. Yeah.
You should be, like, totally good right now.
Yeah.
I don't remember exactly.
Square.
Triangle?
Triangle or square?
Triangle.
Oh, yeah. Durability is nowhere.
Okay.
So hit square.
That's fine. It's nowhere near breaking.
Also, you unequipped your club.
Yeah.
There it is. 120 on 120.
And this one just 101.
No, he just stopped two-handing it. He didn't unequip it.
No,
it's unequipped right now.
Hit right. It's right there.
I have two clubs.
Why do you have two clubs?
I don't know. I picked up a second one.
He must have picked up he must have legit. You know what? Equip the second club instead of the shield.
Yeah, that's what I just did.
Oh, okay.
Did you?
I switched the second club.
Can you show me the two club in it?
Sure. Hold on.
Oh, I want.
Yeah, no, he did. Yeah,
he's been wearing two clubs.
Shit. Yes.
Yeah. Oh. No. Take that off.
No, put your second club in your left hand.
So that I can double.
So you can twin club it.
Is there a reason for this?
It's a good look at this build. Look at this.
This is terrible. That Wooly, there's no benefit.
He's double. It even says in the guide written by Atlas,
double clubbing
and German spy, double clubbing it is quote unquote the shit. All
right, so I have a decision to make.
I had nothing to do with the guide for this game.
You had nothing to do with this one. That is true.
That was Dark Souls 2 and Bloodborne.
It has that equip burden shit.
Yes. No. I know.
So hold on. Like simply having the equipment here versus not on this screen means it adds to the weight.
Yeah, that's
cool. Bear in mind though, Wooly, there are two different weights. There's your equip burden and your item burden. I think that's where we're running into confusion here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which one affects my role?
Burden.
Equip burden. And that's the stuff in those slots.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
See, it's like him knowing he has more equipment puts a weight on his
Beware
mind.
Beware of this enemy's super strong attacks.
They're strong.
He's got red.
This guy is the Red Eye Knight.
Yeah, that's what his name is. His name is the Red Eye.
Oh, okay.
Good.
I heard the consternation
good
in your voice.
Fucking luck, Wooly, is all I've got to say. I'll be cheering you on from a safe distance, brother.
It's the same as every other Souls game. You can beat him.
My
how many mistakes
as
am
many
I allowed
as
to
you
make?
Need.
No, he means before he dies.
Yeah, but remember, you have a roll.
Yeah.
And you can run.
And the other thing about him is his leash range is crazy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, it's super, super
so
long.
So, Wooly, what I'm going to do is I'll just let you figure this out, and if you feel like you want a pro tip...
Okay, I guess you get two
okay,
mistakes.
Okay, I guess so. Yeah. If you feel like you want a little bit of tactical advice, Wooly, just ask.
It's available.
Yeah, no. I know what my tactical advice would
back
be.
Back down.
That would be my advice. That would be back the fuck down.
It would be come back later, yeah.
All right.
Come back later when you are powered
You
up.
Better heal up again.
Yep.
Because he's chasing.
He's chasing.
How
he's,
far this are they going to be chasing this game?
Really
it depends on the enemy, Wooly, but this guy will follow you for a long... Yeah,
to the ends of the earth.
There's an item back there.
All right, this is something interesting.
Oh,
I want him to come out.
He's coming.
Yeah,
he's
gonna
be there in like a second.
All right, that's a stairway.
Wooly, he's blowing up your ass.
Okay, well, touching this bloodstain, someone died.
He will follow you to the stairs.
Take one step forward. Oh, whoa. Wow.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It's fine. Look at that.
Oh.
Oh, talk to this guy.
Can I?
That was a he could have swung at him, Liam.
Well, yeah, but he would have caught up to him and he would have seen the prompt that said talk.
Not necessarily.
No.
Well, not necessarily.
So Liam, I guess this now answers the question of whether he'll meet this first prerequisite, doesn't it?
Yeah, exactly. That's the first step, and it's very easy to miss.
Yeah, because how would you know to jump over
so
that railing
miss.
If you didn't...
That's a good ring.
This is the ring of a thief.
No, you want to use the
other one. Yeah, there you go.
It's the same mistake he made every time in Demon's Soul.
Over
I think I would go so far as to say that this is debatably the best ring in the game for PvE.
You could debate it.
Yeah.
I would debate it.
What would you debate being better,
So this
better,
might
Pat?
Make the Red Eye Knight stop.
What ring would you say is better, Pat, than this? Kling. Fair.
There's no, you can't count Kling.
Fuck yeah, because it's too obviously the actual best one.
Five, six. Holy shit.
You've got items. You've got options.
Yeah, I don't know. Like, what would actually... Oh, yeah, you start...
You've got fire bombs and there's explosive barrels right there.
But they do fine by themselves.
Yeah.
Oh, I really wanted him to hit Ostrava.
Those guys are so salty.
I would have been cool with that, but given that he actually did the jump over the ledge, I was like, okay, no. If he wants to fight Old King Duran, he'll
shit.
Fucking
what's
fight
the,
Old
what's
King
the
Duran.
Lowest type of grass?
The green one.
This is the one.
Okay.
The it's this nice like shade of green, and as it goes from yellower to more of like a white.
Yeah, what's up, Clawham?
That's how it gets stronger.
There you go. Good job.
Is that an explosive barrel?
I'm not crazy.
Look how awesome that dude's shield is.
Ostrava's the shit.
I am Ostrava. That's a cool but impractical shield.
Very impractical.
Super good. It's magic-y.
Brass telescope. Thank you.
So monocular. Like
the, and you're just gonna walk?
Yeah, he's
so Wooly.
Walk away.
He has to go back to his home.
Wooly, I would advise you not to leave him alone quite yet.
Yeah, because he can die.
Yeah, he's a side quest.
NPCs walking is also just a weird thing.
Well, because you're used to all the NPCs being non-combatants, phantoms being your allies.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
This
yeah.
is the only game yeah. that handled it this way in the series.
And it's got a good couple of them too.
Yeah, it does.
Oh man.
So.
I love the enemy types in this area. Like they're player-based enemy types, and they have like the firebomb.
Oh, he's fighting him.
Yeah. Yeah, and he can totally die.
Let's fighting love.
So, you probably already figured it out, Wooly, but Ostrava needs a little bit of babysitting.
A little bit.
Yeah, because you told him.
I told him, but I mean now that he's getting.
You did it. Oops. You confused them.
He's confused about what
to
do.
You threw a tracking icon into his own mouth, and now he's attacking his own mouth.
Oh.
Oh, man. Yeah.
Almost. Ostrava might get
him. Come on, Ostrava.
Oh, come on.
Pull your weight, Ostrava.
You should go grab those items back there real quick before you follow Ostrava back towards the screen.
Yeah. Okay.
And just head all the way back, grab that item, and then there's one to your right.
So, Pat, you see what I mean about those soul remains now, that they work on even fairly strong enemies.
And then I believe there's one to the port.
Yeah, you're totally right, because, like, I've never actually used one. Like, I'm one of those people that never, ever, ever uses, like, items.
Yeah.
Scimitar.
And for the most part, I'm very much the same, and I'm obsessive about managing my inventory. You and I share a lot in common in that regard, Pat, but...
There's a...
Look at that dude! You see that dude?
He went over here.
Yeah, he went that way.
Mm-hmm.
You see that one lone dude staying all the way at the end of the fucking hallway? Looks super cool.
Don't lose just yet, sir. Yeah.
He does have a good amount of health. If you're following him, he should be fine.
And he'll heal himself up when necessary.
No. The main thing is if you leave him alone, eventually his large health pool will just deplete.
Yeah, because he's
and
shit
he has
at
a habit of wandering.
Really quickly kill all these dramas.
He has a habit of wandering into the middle of giant groups of enemies like an idiot.
Yeah.
Now, if he fails, is that one and done?
Yeah, he does not get a second chance.
You have to go New Game Plus to get him back.
Or just start over, because it's only the first level.
Hey, where do you want to go, buddy?
He goes where he goes.
Yeah, he just wanders around.
You don't tell Ostrava Bolteri to go nowhere.
Yeah. All right.
His name's Ostrava Bolteri. That means he's
to be fair, Wooly, so that you don't have to spend excessive amounts of time worrying about him, once you've cleared out this lower area, he'll be safe.
Yeah.
Woof.
This is the spot that murders him, because look at the quantity.
He has wanderlust.
Yep. Aw, come on!
Come on what?
I'm rooting for the guys.
Oh, no.
You're rooting for Dramans?
Yeah.
Draman Club?
Dreglings.
Dreglings, yes.
Is that their name?
They're Dramans to me.
Good memory, I didn't remember
They'll always be Draman to me.
Yeah. They're all part of the Draman Club. It has a lot of drama.
Does it? Oh no, somebody stole my horrible fucking wooden face mask.
Don't forget my flies.
So he's leaving? He didn't want to come down here anyway?
No.
I just want to check it out.
His deal is he wanted to clear out the zone and be
he
like...
He wants me dead more than Pat
does.
Wow, that rating.
Yeah, you got hard stone.
So those stones are for increasing the power of your weapons.
Okay. Because I'm like, I want to stop and check, but this guy is fucking on the move.
That's fine. Don't worry. I don't think you'll find anything that's so,
shit.
Go that way.
That's that
way forward. Yeah. And then starboard.
I think he goes back to the place where you found him.
He wanders around on a set path down here.
Oh, okay. No, he's going this way.
I'm legit starboard. Seeing a lot of people saying the game feed is too dark. But is it supposed to? Because we're playing
the game. We can turn up the brightness in the options menu,
you can.
I think, though.
Yeah.
Of the game.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can see the game feed. It is a little dark. So just fuck.
Actually,
up.
It's brighter on the stream than it is on our TV.
Yeah.
But yeah, Wooly, just crank up the brightness real quick.
In the game.
There's no enemies here. You'll be fine.
Yeah, in the book one.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. System
options.
Battle.
You can put brightness like 7.
Yeah, yeah, that might be fine.
Hopefully that'll do the trick. Oh, yeah, that looks really bright.
That much better.
Although my TV's on game mode, which is like a really, it brightens up a lot, so we could be seeing it.
You can leave him.
Yeah, he's
now.
Done.
Yeah. He's just going to hang around back here. Progression that away. So
that's the end?
For now.
Of stage one.
And then you have to meet him again somewhere else.
Maybe.
Perhaps.
Well, yeah, okay.
Maybe you have to use a special item at the crows.
I see how this works.
He's never played this game before.
So yeah, these are for upgrading stuff. Just
so
like
the
expect.
Worst thing about Demon's Souls is the upgrade mechanic.
Because it's fine until you get to the like level 9 and 10 upgrades, at which point the materials become absurdly rare.
No, that's not even the upgrade.
That's not the bit you mean.
I mean the part where you can only upgrade to certain paths at certain numbers.
You mean branching? Paths? Yeah.
And they all require
what
different
Pat's
materials.
Talking about is the crap where if you want to make a boss weapon, you have to get a very specific type of normal weapon to plus 6, not plus 5 or plus 7, just plus 6.
Yeah.
Just open the chips.
That's true. I had totally forgotten about that aspect of it.
They're not chips.
Just open up the cookies.
So, sorry, just to clarify, like, this is
a scimitar.
Yes. No, but it's, I'm going to get 8, I switched from club damage, which is 75 to 80, but what's going down by 49?
Your damage.
So what's...
Your damage from stat scaling, Wooly, I think. I'm waiting for the stream to catch up.
What are the two numbers?
There? I don't know. I forget.
Spy, do you know
okay,
what the two
yeah,
numbers are?
What you're looking at there, the number that's going down is your damage from stat scaling, and it's going down because for some reason...
Your dex isn't
missing
high
a stat requirement. Yeah. You don't have high enough dex.
That's what it is.
But it's still going up by 5. Even though the scaling
is... No, see, what you actually want to look at is right-hand weapon on the upper left.
Yeah.
See the number that's 31 right now?
Yeah.
Like, that's down from, like...
That's a huge decrease.
From, 91. Like, 91.
That is correct, Willie. Yeah. So, and this is another problem of Demon's Souls in particular, is that the menus really lie to you a lot. It's not always very clear.
There's too much info.
With their absurd lack of clarity,
yeah.
Liam bought, like, a whole box.
Oh, you bought, like, a whole box of cookies?
No, there's no cookies in that box.
Shit.
It's for everyone, though. Would you like some?
He's lying.
GA, I'm not gonna raise my pop shield.
Well, thank you for...
Oh, can I sneak up on these guys?
That guy?
Yeah, you should be fine, yeah.
This is Drummond? A decent backstab test right here.
No!
Oh, no!
Perfect.
Good dodge, though.
Yeah.
He moved on me.
Would you like some of that?
I like one cookie.
Okay, because I haven't... It's not cookies, but anyway.
What are these?
I'm hungry. It's just a big pie, that's all.
Oh, pie.
You have a pie? What kind of pie is it?
Apple crumble.
Dude, you brought apple pie?
Oh, shit. That
sounds awesome.
Yo, Liam brought apple pie, everybody.
Yeah, of course. But I'm actually hungry, so I'm
gonna go eat.
Let's
give big ups to Liam and his apple pie.
Okay, so...
This is big ups.
How much better is this shield? It's not better at all.
No, it's a slave shield.
Got it.
That's the trash shield for trash.
You guys want water or anything?
Good for now, thank you.
Good, thank you.
Hello, friend. Are you red-eyed as well?
No.
He's just normal.
You just got fooled because he's got a message directly.
That's
under
a good old Drummond. Don't worry about it.
That's a hell of a lunch.
Like when I look at the Dreglings, Spy, you'd know this better than the other two there. But like, it's kind of shocking to me how much that exact moveset has appeared in tons of games.
Well, I think they just like reusing the same basic default enemy because Dreglings in Demon Souls effectively came back as Hollows in Dark One.
Yeah, they're exactly the same. They still have the same like thing.
And even in Dark Souls 2, the same enemy type was
present. 1,000 fucking recommendations.
You get that health boost when someone...
It restores your health.
Like you do in Bloodborne?
Yeah, you do. I think.
It restores your health when someone votes your message up.
Okay.
Awesome.
Okay, we're going up to where the Pursuer showed up in last time I was here. There's a blue eye guy.
And there's the way that you didn't come down.
And then there's that path over there. So before I go face our immortal friend.
And then way back, there was the other room before the fog door that you ignored.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Yeah. Okay, thanks for the funnel.
No problem. I'll always be here to funnel you, bro.
Ghost Slayer is not happening. That was a trick that Liam pulled on me.
You should probably look behind you.
No one wants to play Ghost Slayer.
What's
terrible.
Ghost Slayer?
It's a shitty game he told me to play.
Why are we playing Ghost Slayer?
No, we're not.
Okay, so we're playing Ghost Slayer?
Sure.
Yeah, that's what I want. I want you to just give up slowly. Sure.
Oh!
And he's doing way better at this than, like, I even expected.
Than you wanted me to be?
No, it's just like... Like, because it's weird to disassociate your memories of this game with the reality.
Well, Pat, remember you and I were talking the other day about transference of skills from, say, SF4 to SF5? The same principle.
Yeah, and how fundamentals
exactly,
will always carry
yeah,
over.
Yeah, it's the same principle here, I feel like, especially since Wooly has some experience with Dark Souls 2 and Bloodborne. I mean, those are probably the two least like this game, but...
Oh, yeah, totally. You know, so yeah, he sells basic shit, and he also sells a couple weapons
heals
and some armor.
Bleeding.
Yeah, bleeding's been a status effect that's been in
yeah,
like,
actually,
every game.
Demon Souls is probably the most diverse in terms of DOTs of any Souls game as well, because there are three.
You call them DOTs?
Yeah.
Okay. Because, like, maybe it's because I play MMOs, but I always call them dots in my brain because of that video with the DKP points with Onyxia, where that guy, where that like Arabic guy just screaming more dots.
Oh,
more
okay,
dots.
It could be. I've.
Well, no, it's an acronym.
Oh, yeah, I realize that. Like, I've never really used voice chat in MMOs, so that might be why.
Oh, me either. I'm just talking about that stupid fucking DK.
Hey, how about
video.
Some defense?
You could do with a little.
You could get a coat of plate.
Get jeggings. Get the plate jeggings.
I can get a single item.
Yeah, and the coat plate would give you
I'd
the
say
most
that, yeah.
bang for
I'd
your
say
butt.
The coat plate, because it's, yeah, it's
oh,
your torso.
Oh, also, by the way, until you beat this level, you're not allowed to level up.
Oh, okay. Yeah, because I haven't met my lady, right?
Well, that you can talk to her, but she's like, no. Nah.
My level up lady.
And yeah, and yeah, and get a unisex one, because you know, you never know.
Well, because there's a bunch of armor in this game that can only be used by one gender, including a really, really good armor that's only for females.
A really, really awesome thong.
No, it's actually like a burlap sack executioner thing.
A burlap thong.
It's fucking awesome. Burlap thong would be horrible.
I don't know.
That would chafe so fucking bad.
It takes all kinds. Don't judge my kink.
Matt, you're...
It is the end. He's
you're
really
talking
excited.
To a German. I'm not in a position to judge anyone's kink.
Hell, at least the demons yeah. I forgot. I was totally German.
Wow, alright.
I like that guy.
Yeah, there's always that, like, slightly nefarious...
I still think the Undead Merchant in 2... Merchant. Sorry, in 1 is the best. The guy that drops the
Yeah, he's... He's doubly awesome when you find out that you can charm him with undead rapport and have him fight enemies.
Dude, what?
Well, you think about other merchants like the guy from Star Fox Adventures.
I kid you not, Pat. That's
and then there's...
Yeah!
Did he kill himself?
Maybe not. There's frame rate room.
Maybe not. He probably did. No, he's not. He's fine.
He's alive, you shit.
I love frame rate room so much.
What an asshole.
Mm-hmm. It's so good.
To be fair, he's got a good strat.
Yeah,
wait for someone to come into the room with a bunch of shit.
It's a really good strat.
And survive by hiding
so
in the
Wooly,
corner.
So, Wooly, that is what would have happened to your face if you had just walked ahead instead of jumping down to meet Ostrava.
Yep.
Ah.
So, like, that's where you jumped over.
And that's where...
And so you... And it's like this curvy little S thing that you have to go around. So you walk in and you don't see him because he's blocked from view.
And then he does that
And then he
you.
Does that and the frame rate explodes and you die. And you go, this game is bullshit.
Okay. All right, so there's that pathway.
And then there's the one still all the way back.
All the way back, yeah.
But now you look like...
Also, this is another fucking death room. I saw these barrels, and I was like, any minute now.
Well, yeah,
but it never
but
happens.
But you came in through it backwards.
Right.
That's
right,
why.
Okay. And then we have this area.
Oh, watch out!
Yeah, you look... So, you didn't see those guys earlier, but they were perched up on top of the on the left there. And they came down and have been hanging out here the whole time.
I've noticed that the AI in this
Liam
game
is here.
Spends a lot of time just running into walls.
Holy shit. Now everyone gets to watch me eat food live.
I'm good for now, Liam. Thank you. Like, I'll have something
can
later.
Can we start one of those, like, Korean fucking food things?
Rate the food as you eat it?
Just like, oh, yeah. That's the shit. I have to push this away from me so people don't hear my...
Okay.
Super loud mouth noises.
This was another drop over here. I'm not sure where.
Back
that
down to where you ran into a Strava.
Liam, do you have like a whole Hungry Man tray?
Oh, quiet for a second. Sorry. Well,
back
where
down to where
spot?
You ran into a Strava. So it's just a loop back. There's no need to worry about it.
Gotcha. Okay.
Liam, this is delicious.
It's from Rockaberry. It's super good. And no, I just forgot to eat, so I stopped and picked up a bunch of food because I'm hungry.
Looks like a hungry.
I
man.
Also forgot to eat.
Here, you want a 2-bite brownie?
No, I'm good. Thank you.
Here, I'll feed it to you.
I just had
Live.
A cookie. I'm fine, Liam. Name, please.
Oh, he doesn't want it.
I was eating junk all weekend.
He should have shoved the cookie into his face. Just like
I actually kind of did, but...
No, but like rub it.
Yeah, what fell on me there?
My phone.
Oh, damn it.
It's not my dick, all right?
Yeah, all right? You would barely feel it.
It's
yeah,
nice. It's nice to want things.
That's solid.
I love your no pants so hero.
Eh, body's good enough for now. Baz is pretty cocksure.
It really looks like his legs are all burnt, like he spent too much time in the hot tub. And that guy's just taking a liking to you.
Okay, so before I go through that gate, let me deal with this guy that's coming all the way up to meet me.
Wow, he looks like
you mean the guy that
before,
you just pushed off a four-story drop, who should have died when he took Demon Souls fall damage. He's still alive.
I assumed he did, and I should have waited for the souls to come to kick in.
I appreciate that his first thought was, "I have to climb back up and kill that guy."
I'm eating the food, guys. Okay, jeez.
What are you looking for?
I'm looking for validation on eating the food.
Just move the mic away while you do it, and it'll be fine.
I did.
Oh, okay. All right. So that first funnel.
Yeah.
Let's go back there.
No, it's the wrong way.
Shit.
It was well intentioned, though.
That's the wrong way too.
Up here?
Yeah. Jeez, dude.
And there's a glowy. There's a treasure. Yeah. You got the treasure.
Man, Liam, you saved a day here.
Is it good?
Oh, it's super good.
Good. I'm excited to eat it too, actually.
I'm talking about the bridge funnel, by the way, Pat.
Yeah, I know.
Okay. Oh, yeah, this is where I fell over.
You just
came
so far.
Yeah, you're right, you're right, you're right. Okay.
Oh, this stuff is so good.
Yes, so I came out there, and then there was this way. What you got over here? What you got in that bag?
It's pie.
Ambush
pie? It's one whole Rockaberry pie.
Oh god, apple crumble is the best from Rockaberries.
Yeah,
here, do
exactly.
You want some? I'll just put it in your mouth. I'll just shove it in your bag.
I'm not gonna stop you.
I'm gonna stop me.
Okay.
Because that's gross.
Alright.
People eating food is the worst. That's why Earthling Cinema censors it. If you ever watch Earthling Cinema and see that, like, whenever
anyone's
eating food on screen, they put
they
a big
blur
censor?
It?
Yeah.
That's fantastic. No.
There's a lever.
What is it exactly? I've heard of it once, but I don't really know.
Here it comes. He's got a flaming thing.
You coming or not? You coming?
He's coming. Oh, no, he's not coming
anymore. What a
anymore,
champion!
Though.
Earthling Cinema is a show on the Wisecrack channel.
Uh-huh.
It's just a film analysis. And the guy pretends to be a space alien.
That was so
grabs.
Stupid.
Oh, okay.
Do it
that
again. Do
really
it
good,
again.
Actually.
It's actually super good.
Oh, wait. They're really weak.
Nice. That was good.
Plus, you needed their Shang Tsung soul sucked into
so
your head.
So the pathing in this game wasn't quite up
well,
to snuff.
Yeah, I was going to say that a lot of people spend their time rubbing up against walls like the AI just...
It's fine for the most part.
There are spots where the pathing gets really sketchy, yes, but...
Can I get this guy?
Usually those are only in really narrow areas and on catwalks.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Which is like maybe 15 to 25% of the game.
Turpentine?
But it's not as bad as it sounds, actually.
That stuff causes brain damage.
Yeah, go read
now,
that.
Now, Wooly, I don't believe you're going to be able to use turpentine on your club because it's made of wood. You need a metal weapon for that, so...
Can he climb over this if
he
walks
can't.
Into it?
No.
You wish!
I can roll into it, though.
You can roll into it, though.
Oh, can you?
Breaks
you
the chain, at least.
You want to break both the chains and see what happens?
I'm the breaker
you
of chains. I am now Daenerys Targaryen.
I wonder what that did.
Hear me roar.
It did something.
I won't be nude anymore on season 7.
Is it true that shit's gonna spoil the books?
Her nudity? Probably.
It's gonna spoil the books?
Yeah.
We're past the books now.
Fuck the books.
Yeah, no.
Oh, no!
It's crazy bullshit.
That's fine. Fall damage is minimal.
Yep.
Woo. But all these Ric Flairs...
If you survive, your reward will be good.
Yeah, if Wooly botches it here, I'm gonna laugh super hard.
Yeah.
I'm about to botch.
Get back up the stairs. Get back up the stairs.
Oh, man, this is the best.
This is not where you want to botch.
Eat your weed!
It's a shame that the Demon Souls guy didn't know about the glory of vape culture.
Yep. See which vape stores in Montreal have opened and closed today.
It's pretty ridiculous.
Is it that ridiculous?
Dude, on Verdun, at one point on my street, over the course of 2 months, 6 vape shops opened, and now only 3 of them are left.
and it's been like 4 months since the beginning of that.
It's like
and
vape in, store in survivor.
The great vape boom.
In business.
Of 2014.
In business, that is light years.
Yeah.
Are there drop attacks in this game?
Nope.
No.
I tried to do one.
You can drop an attack.
I tried to do one.
You know, all you can do in this game is Goomba Stomp. Although that does have some tactical applications. The Goomba Stomp in Demon's Souls will stun enemies.
Mm-hmm.
If I disguise myself, I can proceed.
That guy loves it. He's not into it. He loves this music.
Well, what if I don't have a disguise?
You'll be fine.
I don't trust that.
You will actually be fine.
Okay. That's a dude that knows how to party.
So this is why you didn't want to botch.
You open up like this shortcut.
Clean
yes.
ring. Put that
put
on.
Put it on put and that never take on. It off.
Literally never take it
don't
off.
Don't even okay. just put it on. Don't even ask what it does.
Yeah, just
don't
put
even
on,
read what it does.
Yeah,
just put it on.
Will it give me space if I need my alone time?
Just put it the fuck on.
You already spoiled yourself.
He's ruining it, guys. He's ruining the stream.
Hey!
Look at that.
That's
isn't
nice.
Massive,
pretty good?
Massive bump.
That's fantastic.
Yeah. This was why Pat said it was the best ring in the game, and we both instantly disqualified
yes.
it from the running.
Yeah, because it's not even
yeah,
fair.
Yeah, there's no contest. Yeah.
That's like saying Meta Knight's the best character in Brawl. Well, yeah.
It shouldn't even count as a ring.
Shouldn't even count.
Hey, are you an invader?
You'll know no. if an invader okay. shows up, Willie, because you'll be in body form when they do.
Yeah. You're just a oh, that was a blood thing I've touched. Oops,
so this is also an abstract kind of shortcut.
Man, you're right, S&D. This is the most boring thing in the world. This is super boring.
See, that's the beginning right there.
Yeah. Okay, makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
All right, now what did I pick up?
You picked up rag.
Which you can't even
ragged,
wear it. It's female
edge.
Only.
Oh, well.
Mm, that's true. Gender-specific armor.
Yeah, I was talking about because you were out of the room.
Oh, so
because what's her
Meralda.
Name? The executioner.
Yeah.
Meralda. Her gear is sick as shit. You got to be a lady to wear it.
So mm-hmm. it makes a difference whether or not what
gender
you pick.
Yes, and this is the
pick,
only
then.
Game
yeah.
in the series where they did that, and I'm not even sure to this day why they made that choice, but.
I think they
realized
Lunar
Hawk,
it was a bit
I'm never
silly.
Watching Legend of the Galactic Heroes. Stop asking me.
I'm totally gonna watch that.
Okay, you watch it, and then tell me to watch it, and then I'll still not watch it.
Wow, that back down.
No, I hear super amazing things about it. Everyone is like, that's one of the best.
Okay, is that
ever
the
made.
One where like the little kid gets his head blown off with like a bazooka?
No, that's Ideon.
That's Barefoot Gen.
That's Oh, there's multiple.
It is.
Okay. Japan makes good video games.
Okay.
I meant anime. Whatever.
They're
I almost
different.
Fell asleep on the way here. Whatever, man. Today's the worst day to
you
do
you can
this.
Sleep now while people are watching.
I guess I can sleep now.
No one.
You remember that?
No one can stop you from sleeping.
You remember that Resident Evil marathon stream that I think was before 6 came out?
Hold on. Yeah, did the red guy go back to his post?
Yeah.
Okay.
Actually,
well,
he's,
no,
well, he's walking
there.
Into a wall as
oh
I stand.
He is stuck on a post, but not his.
So you got lucky because normally he would have chased you like. Almost, he would
a long way, a long,
a long way.
Way.
So the zoning out thing is a relatively newer convention, or character. And
no, for the most part, in this
yeah.
game
and
fine.
Remember, Wooly, also you're wearing the thief ring. I think it might be worth telling you exactly what that ring does, so that you know,
mm-hmm.
because there might even be points when you choose to unequip it because of how broken it is.
It
said that I stay silent.
Yeah, but what it actually does is it decreases your detectability.
Well.
Range. Or, alternatively, it decreases enemies' detection
What it
range.
Does mm. is it makes you completely invisible and undetectable outside of a 15 or 20-foot radius. And that's to other players mm. as well as enemies.
Oh my god, that's fantastic.
I didn't know
it
that
works
in
PvP.
PvP.
Have you ever been in PvP in this game
yeah,
and someone just invised out of nowhere and backstabbed you?
No,
never?
I didn't.
Well, that's what it is. It's not a super rare situation, but... If you didn't do it too much,
yeah,
that's you missing it.
True. Attack. And there's a spell which does the same thing, but it's even more powerful, and it makes you undetectable outside
yeah.
of about 5 feet.
So, 'cause it's a
that spell's
weapon.
Amazing, yeah.
So what you'd sometimes have happen in...
No, you can't break that. I know it says attack, you can't break that.
Okay.
It means this.
Yeah, you can.
Wait,
what
no,
are you talking
about?
No,
you can totally
break
that.
You've
Why
got
wasn't
to hit the front of it, where those planks are holding the boulders in.
Oh, you got to hit the front of it. Is that it?
Okay. Don't stand in front of it.
I had assumed
don't
it was a different
spot.
The frame rate balls.
No, I had assumed it was a different spot because it wasn't working for some reason.
Go, my minions, go!
Oh, there's still... Oh, I thought there was one guy left.
Do yourself a favor and check out the vista that you're at.
Yeah. Just keep looking. Keep going.
Okay.
Port.
So
starboard.
That... is where the final boss is.
Over there.
Yeah.
And that's sick. One of the fantastic things that this game does.
Look a little starboard, little north.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey!
Yeah, there he is.
Look at him. Look
What's
guy.
Your name?
Hey, I gotta throw this plate in the garbage. Hold on.
Great view.
Or
so,
just put it on the table or something.
How do I raid again? Select, he said?
No.
To write a message?
Yeah,
well, that's weird. To write that's a message. You take the headphones off. I'm like,
how do I give? How do I rate a message?
To
like,
rate,
hey,
it'll just
job.
Say rate message, but you have to rate a message you've just read when you press select.
Fair enough, Lunar.
So you can't. Yeah.
Oh, you have to do it
you
that
see?
Way. Oh, yeah. That's weird. Okay, I understand.
They streamlined that instantly.
Yeah, they figured it out
because it was
later.
An evident
gotcha.
Thing.
Oh man. Okay, now this mic is in my way. Let me just.
So.
So it's. It's been about an hour. I wanted to just take a little break and check the messages that came in from people.
Sure.
I need a good stopping point, though.
This is a good stopping
any,
point. Is this
any
safe?
Any place where it's you're fine. Not being attacked is a good stopping point, Wooly.
Yeah.
All right.
Before I forget, by the way, just one real quick thing. The thing, you see it says Boletarian Palace in the top corner?
Yep.
Right next to it, you got that little icon.
Mm-hmm.
That thing in the middle is your world tenancy. The color of it, so it's white right now.
And if it changes?
It'll be black.
When you're in black world.
Okay. Yeah, black world.
Yeah.
How okay. do I get it to battle tendency?
Nobody knows what you mean, Wooly.
Well, no, we know what he means,
we know.
But we don't.
We know.
Have no There's no answer, enough. Really.
We know.
All right.
Okay, I admit then, I'm the only one who doesn't know what Wooly meant.
It's JoJo Part 2. It's the name of it's the JoJo's Bizarre Adventure.
Gotcha.
Just don't worry about it. All right. So,
please don't tell me that Max sent anything.
Let's start out. Let's see what we got here. All right, we got we got 16 coming in from Noster 1XB Wacka Hype Inc. Thank
yeah,
you.
Yeah, Wacka Hype. Wacka White Hype.
TDS462 says, "Thank you shitlords for bringing me the joy and getting me through. Why did you cut off message?" Let me read the rest of it.
Are you doing the fucking message thing and the message broke?
I'm doing it, but it's not showing the full message.
Are you for real?
Yeah, it's a little bit weird.
Well, let's thank him.
Thank you. Oh, here we go. For getting me through some troubles over the past 3 years. Right on, dude. Thank you. Anonymous sends $5. You guys watching the Fire
Bros?
Hey,
Anani.
Fine Bros Burn or what? I guess not. We're playing Demon Souls, man. Saiyan 1277
yes,
says you guys are the best. Thank you very much, dude. Dash Rendar.
Yeah.
Sends $5. Yo, I'm watching the KI Cup and this at the same time.
That's
Killjoy
tough.
Hex says, fuck boy, man. 2016, when's Ninja Storm 4?
The worst part about that is it's a hashtag. And it's going to happen.
Chowi says, thanks for being the hypest gaming / wrestling / Simpsons quoting
machine
Empire around. Haven't stopped watching since 2012.
Thanks, bro.
Cool.
Blizz Nasty says, congratulations on stream. Sub button when? Well, after we do a couple of these, I guess, Blizz Nasty.
If we put a sub button and then didn't stream for 4 months, we'd look like fucking massive assholes.
Huge, huge turds indeed. G-Zero says, this may be the first of in a series of donations. I hope you guys get... The Bone Crusher, Ostrava must live.
Spy, I think you can agree that we're all going to try and do our best to get the fucking bone.
Yeah,
the bone
and we're going to kind of have to ignore chat on that because lots and lots of people so far seem to be, no, just shut up and ignore world tendency. But no, if we
no,
want
you
the
can't.
DDS, we have no choice.
Is it a bone
Dragon,
crusher
Dragon
or a bone,
bone
smasher?
Smasher?
It's a bone smasher.
Smasher.
Oh,
damn. I like crusher.
I said crusher before, too.
Because crusher is, that's important, because that's fucking
right.
Def Jam.
Yeah.
Yeah, I said that.
Big dumb
like
fat black guy.
30 minutes
you
ago.
You will be destroyed.
Yeah, you pull a big dumb fat black guy out of the stone and swing him around.
This big dumb fat black guy can hardly be called a weapon.
If you hit with just his fro, you get extra damage. Oops.
If you tip it.
Controller. You're right.
Okay, did you see that?
Yep.
Okay, that...
Is why.
That is why. There were so many fucking posts on GameFAQs when this game came out. I was like, I just came and picked up my controller, and Thomas is fucking dead.
Yeah.
He's the best.
You're super right. What did Plague say? Plague says...
I have distracted
Twitch
you.
Title. Never mind.
Stream a better game,
that's
he says.
Ancient.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, Jiro said that. John the Hero says, keep on fighting. We'll see you at MAGFest. See you guys
there.
Yeah,
cool.
MAGFest is going to be sick. Wooly Stole Ma Pie says, Ma Brand.
I bet that's a reference to that sunglasses ad.
Okay. Iraq 2012 says, the demons, souls. Thank you. Jiro says, the Ghost Slayer needs to be pushed for SummerSlam.
No, it doesn't.
Ghost Slayer is really good, and I don't know why you're sandbagging
it. Because it's a fucking nothing game.
Nostra
nothing
TXB, very, very huge thanks, dude.
Very
generous. Awesome.
Generation.
And he just says, smiley face.
Well, not the words, but he or she made a smiley face.
Thank you very
thank
much.
Thank you very much, dude. And then we have one from Year OTV.
Which
when's
is
Serial Video?
Year Zero.
It's
did,
it's
we made
on
that, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
It's being. It's
Wooly,
good. It's
I hope
to
point
made
out that was like 15 out of 42.
That's a good spread.
There's a page too.
There's like 27 more.
Okay. No, we read these.
Oh, I was out of the room.
We read these.
Oh, now it's out of 64. Oh God!
Is there a page two?
Yeah, here we go. Detroit. Yeah, so I'm gonna stop where I was. So Detroit Sentai, I love you guys when you talk shit about Detroit. Thank you. Radio Voice says fuck Boyvan for life. Alpha Centauri says a
Alpha
German
Centauri
spy versus Pat. One Centauri tells Wooly the more supportive and meaningful things, and the other tells him he's bad and needs to be as good as him. Who is who, and who's Wooly in who Wooly's heart? Frag Dapper.
I'm the good one.
Are you?
Yeah.
Pretty sure German tried.
Gaming Maiden says, great stream, when's Omicron?
Fucking never. I can't get that game to run.
I
really?
Hey.
I couldn't get it to run back in like 2005.
It was free.
Did you try
it was,
now?
It was free
no,
not long
no
ago.
I also don't want to play
in
it
memory of Bully, so I picked it up. Crownless King says,
yeah, Crownless King.
Risei's best girl, fuck Chie. Well, your name is cool. I'll give you that.
Here
that's
we go with
something
the wife.
Thank
again
you, though. I know.
Always
they never stop. Twin Ego says, donating some cash to say Yukiko is the best. I will fight you to the ends on this. Wow.
No one will fight with you, bro.
Okay,
the
man
best waifus are the
call
ones that aren't even on the battlefield.
And Dreth 1997 says, you guys are my favorite people to watch and listen to.
Thank you.
In the whole world. Thank you so much for everything you do. Seriously, love you tons. Love you guys.
That's very kind.
Super awesome.
Now let's get back to doing our jobs badly.
Yep. Let's do that. And then we will get back to these in another hour or so. When the time's right.
Mm-hmm.
Sounds good.
What do we do if there's too many and there's like 1,000? That's a good problem to have. That's the answer.
You start reading only the first word of every one.
Yeah.
And you try and make a little story?
You just go.
I'm gonna space it out and then come back to it and then do another couple.
No, you know what we can do? What we can do
no
is,
matter what happens by the end, we'll get through
them. If there's too many, we can all just leave. And Wooly
Wooly can do it solo?
Yeah. It's a good problem to have.
You know, we're mean, but we're not that mean.
I'm pretty mean, actually.
Yeah, you know what? Sure. I won't fight you on that.
Yeah.
Look at him, backing him up.
You're a nicer guy than you appear. No, I'm not.
You gonna throw anything? No.
Yeah.
Well, sometimes.
Look.
Like right there.
You
know what I love about that firebomb animation is that it looks really similar to the big spear stab. Like he does the on both?
That was ugly. That was really ugly.
You defeated Agni and Rudra.
These fucking two soldiers with their team hyper combos getting in there.
I thought I could roll through the cracks, but I didn't.
Dude, look how far he went just by that little baby nudge.
Yeah.
Soldier's Lotus. What am I looking at?
Cures Bleeding.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm right here.
You back? Cool.
You know, I keep forgetting that I'm not just watching this like one of your videos on YouTube, that I'm actually
you're
here.
You're a participant.
Yeah.
Because you're so entertained, right,
I'm
Spy?
I'm entertained.
Yeah.
Let's start up this
read
way
that message.
Beware of not using caution ahead.
Beware
man,
of not using
they
it.
They were really like obtuse in Demon's
what,
Souls.
With the messages, Pat?
Be aware.
Yeah, the messages were so obtuse.
This reminds me of the bridge in Bloodborne.
Which one?
The one in near the beginning of the game, right before you fight Gascoigne.
Yep.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I remember.
Where
remember,
they push
where
the
they
big,
throw
the fireball.
The big fire
it kind of reminds me of that.
Yeah.
Oh,
no,
it's
I,
like
I don't
a
disagree
a million
with you
fucking dudes.
Yeah. Look at these cowards.
There's more guys on screen than I remembered.
Mm-hmm. What are those wings flapping about?
Nothing. Don't worry about it. It's no big deal.
Don't worry about it, buddy.
There nice you go.
Oh, shit.
Don't worry about it.
They're easing you into the experience, Wooly. Can't you tell?
Is he gonna do it?
It was just as scary as.
No, he's just checking it out.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, he was like, hey,
he was sniffing around. He just caught
a whiff.
Who's
gonna swing first, Wooly or Dragon?
Dragon.
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 What is that from again?
Dragon.
Dragon.
Stupid Street Fighter.
Okay. Stupid Street Fighter's good answer.
No, he triggers when I get far enough onto the
sure does.
So you're just not having any of that? Or are you gonna do it slow and steady?
Stupid Street Fighter stupidity.
There's a couple ways through this situation.
On YouTube.
Yeah, good luck.
That's a good start.
That's the best way through.
That's a good start. Look how far he fucking goes, I love it.
Yeah.
Woo!
He's hanging around too.
Okay, now's your chance.
Yeah, okay.
What's the animated movie with all the dragons? Flight of the Dragons?
Okay,
awesome,
so since
movie.
That
you actually do have to wait until he goes back.
So, you might want to check.
Let's see what's over
here. Yeah, go this way first.
Because that's clearly,
that
busy.
Seems like it's the danger zone.
That bridge has the word vacant on it.
Yes.
On its door.
Go ahead,
which is great, because there's a million guys there, and that's the first time they ever pull that gimmick.
Dragon, rock the dragon, Dragon Ball Z.
I love the guy who just screams at the end. Like, he said, one guy says, yeah.
Fire defense? Do I even have any fire?
No, you don't.
No, you don't.
And he's over here,
so,
too. Oh!
Really,
the reveal!
Agni and fucking Rudra.
This is what people in chat were begging you to use the so-called 200 arrow method on. Because I'm going to just tell you this right now. The red dragon there,
can't even lock on.
If you hit him enough with projectiles, he will eventually just give up and piss off.
And leave.
The blue one, you cannot... You can't damage the blue one at all, but he can damage you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. Now, will he breathe if I
approach? Oh, yeah. No, totally.
Yeah.
So he's going to just be a shit to
whichever side
I'm on.
Like, look at what's there.
All the horrible burning corpses.
It's
with
a
loot.
I believe you can go down the side of the cliff safely.
You can, but the really good stuff is up where it's dangerous. Because where else would it be?
Yeah, you know? Exactly.
Well,
yeah.
You're going to have to channel your inner Jay Baruchel because you're going to have to learn how to train these dragons.
Oh, okay.
Can't believe you went there.
This is safe, right, Liam?
Yeah, this is safe.
I believe this is safe.
Like, he tried.
Yeah.
So,
but it's safe.
Yeah.
The thing is it said, like, earlier there was a note that said, oh, no!
Oh, I thought it was safe. Is it not
safe?
It's safe.
He'll you've got a chance.
He will breathe fire at you down there, but he cannot hit you.
Okay. But
that looked really not safe.
There was a note that said, like, with world tendency, you can come back here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And that's the case. So with white world tendency, those
one
dragons
dragon
go away.
Goes away.
Okay, Shard of Archstone.
What? Which one
the
leaves?
One.
The red one?
The red one.
Okay.
Oh, I love these instant corrections. Fixing possible huge mistakes later on.
I don't know.
Your dragon sneeze.
In the grand scheme of things, that's not that big of a mistake.
Now you're making me second guess myself. Does the second dragon...
Spy, why are you fucking ruining our stream?
Nah, you're good.
You know who'd really ruin the stream? Bunny
Hop. Oh.
So you don't get rid of your souls using this one.
Yeah.
You just keep them on.
Yeah.
It's a homeward bone.
So hang on to it, because you might need them.
It's a home bone. Okay.
You're a ghost, right? Yeah, you're a ghost.
He's a ghost.
He's just ghosting you, man.
Yeah.
And
home bone.
Okay.
So,
hey, run. Run while he's not
there. Yeah.
So
I joked last time, but this is actually
there's a couple
there's
ways.
There's more dudes though.
Oh, they respawn.
No, just
they're never. Them. So those dudes tell you where the fire doesn't hit.
Yeah, I guess
because
so, yeah.
they're well. Now you
now
fucked
you're
it
too
up.
Late.
Yeah,
you
yeah,
fucked
yeah,
it up.
Yeah, yeah. I was waiting for the wings, but it's okay.
So no, the trick is to go over to the other one
and then sprint.
Maybe
all the way back
get one right. item, and then when he comes back.
Okay, you're playing fucking Ring Around the Rosie.
Playing chicken.
Well,
yeah, Ring Around the Rosie.
Because he has to animate and actually get over
and
there.
You get more time
right?
if he starts breathing fire and commits to that animation.
So right now, get one and run. Run.
You might be able to grab a second.
No
And
way.
Once you've grabbed...
In fact, you can't even grab
once
one.
Once you've grabbed an item... This
Whoa!
Wow, lucky.
Whoa!
Fuck
very,
off.
You have no
lucky.
HP in your bar.
Fuck
You're good.
Off.
You're good now. You're good.
Wow!
That's bullshit.
Okay.
That's lucky.
Time
yeah.
to test out some.
Waiting
good
for the stream. Oh god, the stream just caught up. That magic pixel, though.
Yeah.
Holy shit, Marvel. That
okay.
was great.
So what you want to do is he's there right now.
So
you want to get to the landing with all your stamina,
and then just
and
blitz.
Then just go.
Yeah.
And then like now the four guys.
You'll have to deal with them afterwards.
I have to get through them.
It's the only way.
It won't be hard to get. Through.
Oh,
they
look
were
at that
shield
stream
to shield.
Explosion! I love it.
They're not shield to shield at all.
Okay.
Yeah. Save your stamina. Save your stamina.
The other thing is, we'll leave.
Like, start running when they start aggroing so that they don't just chase you down.
Oh, okay. This is the worst.
Oh, sorry, sorry, sorry. Yeah, yeah.
By the time you, yeah. But yeah, so by the time you get now. Past those four guys, totally you'll good. Be safe.
You might want to go down the stairs anyway.
Oh.
Woo! Oh. Oh my God! Did he just get lucky, and they moved to a place where
they're gonna get wrecked. They didn't get hit. Their health bars would have popped.
That's unfortunate.
I don't think they'll follow you though.
Oh, they're stuck there.
They're good. They're okay.
They're just...
No, the dragon's still there.
Wooly, what are you doing?
He's gonna keep dive bombing
that forever.
Okay. Now that you're here, there's no other way to distract him.
Okay. There's the other way too, but you might want to open this first.
Yeah. Hey, Spy, is the phalanx weak to blunt?
He's weak to pretty much everything as long as good. See, that's the thing. I'm not sure how much strat I want to talk for that boss because I kind of want to let Wooly figure it out. You know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
Because there is one particular mana.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Now, based on how many bosses, Pat, you've compared to Phalanx in the previous games, I think I know what to expect.
Do you? Really?
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Which ones are you thinking specifically, Wooly?
Because every time we had a boss with tons of adds in it, Pat would say, this is Phalanx.
Yeah, that's
Pat says this is X a lot.
So, I specifically remember...
There's still the other
There's still the other stuff, yeah.
Mm-hmm. No,
outside. And port.
To your left.
Port. There you go.
You have to use outdated terms that no one knows.
We're on a boat here. Oh no!
What?
I said that horrible word that you banned for some reason.
because there's a whole crew of people that got pissed off, but then ended up loving it and becoming the diamond boats.
Perfect.
Why? Why did you do this?
It's a whole gag that you had to be in the stream for the last 2 weeks to get.
You had to be there, but it's gonna last the rest of your life.
Some of it started to bleed over into my fucking free company.
Hey, I'm an idiot. What did I just pick up?
Oh.
And the old soldier's, the old soldier's soul? It's just souls.
Okay.
I believe.
You picked up bullshit, that's what you picked up.
Mm-hmm. So, Wooly, maybe it's worth letting you know the stuff that the dragons were guarding in case you care to go back for it.
There's a purple flame
shield, which you probably won't be able to use quite yet, because I think it requires one more point of strength than you have. But more
But it's fantastic.
It's fucking baller.
It is fantastic.
Good.
There's also a ring that increases your equip burden, so it lets you wear heavier stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
But, like, the shield for everybody that's gonna go for a strength build, or at least up to 16, like, that thing is fucking killer for when you go to 2.
What is
turpentine? It's a flame buff.
It lights your weapon on fire.
But it won't work on wooden weapons.
Right, okay.
Think fire paper.
Fire paper.
Does it actually not work on wooden weapons?
You can't buff wooden weapons with it.
Jeez, that's a detail that I never, ever picked up.
Yeah, I actually never knew that. I haven't bothered to use the wooden weapons.
Well, the thing is, to be fair... Very few people use the wooden weapons in this game because they're not generally that great.
Yeah.
So it's
exactly that's an interesting detail that they even bothered
to answer that guy. Yeah, I'm totally playing 14 again.
What guy? You're speaking to nobody.
I could I saw the comment, but I didn't see the name until it had scrolled past.
Oh, there's this tough team.
This is a good combo.
Oh,
that was your moment. To own it, whatever the rest of that rap song is.
Never let it go. Whoa. That's a good one. No.
I'm not as good at
this combo
as you guys at the rap
fucking
music.
Combo.
You have to swing your club if you want to hit them.
Yeah, welcome to my life doing those LPs, guys.
Well,
no, it's because when I took some damage and I was like, oh shit, let me not die first and then I'll hit them. You know?
Don't worry, I'll jump in there and
get
the good
one piece of advice I would give you, Wooly, if you're finding you're bashing your face on people's shields, kick their guard open.
Yeah. Because it's actually
in this
really
game, especially. It's well worth doing. It's not like in Dark Souls 2 where
it takes so long
that they'll just counterattack you because they read inputs.
By kick.
Forward and R1.
This?
Yeah.
Forward and R1. It's, okay. Sometimes it's a kick, sometimes it's a shove, sometimes it's just a huge weapon bash.
Is that dependent on your class?
Yeah. Weapon.
Your weapon. Weapon, okay.
But it is labeled. Oh my god. But it is labeled as a kick, kick.
And actually, if you unequip your weapon and just do it with your bare fist, it's a headbutt.
Yeah, that's true. That doesn't apply if you have the Cestus equipped,
I believe
though,
it does.
It?
With any fist weapon, it's a headbutt.
Does it?
No, with the fist weapon, it's the headbutt, because I remember that fucking video people put out of the
one I linked you where you headbutt buff your fist weapon and then your headbutt does buff damage.
Yeah, because and because it's so fast, it breaks.
Well,
all
you
the
can
AI.
Infinitely stunlock people with it because the headbutt
He's even
the
got
headbutt
a spear.
Is so fast that the stun lock, if you get someone in a corner with it,
he's all
the stun lock is inescapable.
Oh, this is adorable. I love this.
Oh, that's interesting.
I love this. I love this so much.
Okay. Oof. I couldn't shield break him there.
No, because he's made out of a shield.
He's not holding it.
He's a
his shield is his face.
There you go.
So
he's just no face with a shield.
I believe you left an item by that note.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's that thing. It's the face fucking shield that Plague always talks about.
In his backyard.
Creepy. That fucking...
Yo, Superbait. Somebody let Superbait fucking post that goddamn headbutt video because it's the fucking shit.
That goop was holding us, like a phalanx?
Well,
anyway.
Wooly, I'm going to say that this is one of the cool elements about the game design in all of the Souls games, but you see it a lot in Demons, I feel like, maybe more than the others, where they introduce you to a concept early on in kind of a small, surreptitious way that you might just gloss over. And then they're like, well, okay, remember that concept or don't, but you might be glad you did.
Man, yeah. man, Spy talks so much better than
no.
us. Like, I don't know what surreptitious actually means. What does it mean, Spy?
Hiding in the darkness.
Is that what it means?
No. This thing. No.
Surreptitious. It means on the down low, sort of under the radar.
All right.
Yeah. So you've pushed him into the corner where he's like more or less invincible.
Just leave.
If I were you, I would just go pull the lever down there and call it a day.
Yeah.
He's in a corner. He'll pull himself out of the corner by the
he's
time you're done
with that.
He's
not going to do nothing.
He's
going
to throw stuff at
you. He can't hit you from there.
He can't hit
he's
you
He's not
going to
chase you very far, I'll tell you that much.
Well, they're super fucking
he's
slow.
He's kind of a blobbo, well, so...
Just, if you'll regret it if you don't
kind
pull
of the
a
point,
lever.
Yes.
That's a big thing in this game. Hey, you didn't open that door. Hey, you didn't pull that lever and then you died. Oh, you're in a bad day now.
Okay.
See, he's not gonna.
You can just leave him, man.
All right, fine.
Yeah.
He can't chase
He's in a kind of nasty corner, so. Yeah.
And we are now on the bridge?
You're now at the end of the first level!
Which, coincidentally, is right at the beginning of the first level.
Where this thing landed.
Yeah.
Really? In the cutscene.
That's the scraping spear. So that's a big version
of
the scraping
spear.
You
had better
hope
you never see one of those on another player, Wooly.
Oh, yeah.
I see. Okay.
I'm going to burst out laughing if instant he gets body form, like within 10 seconds of zoning into another invasion.
It cannot be understated how good the scraping spear is.
Or it's so, how bad.
Because people will kill themselves to get away from
or how
it.
Bad. I'm going to say that I will insist that Wooly goes body form for the 3-3 boss fight. I will insist.
Here we go.
Yeah, it's probably the right choice.
Is that why I never got
full
version?
Yes,
you have
online,
to be body form?
And you have to
And... Okay.
Yep.
Welcome.
Enjoy that shit. Do it better.
Good luck, Wooly. Apply what you've learned.
Got it.
Man, okay, I know you've talked about it a lot, Wooly, and you never found a really good excuse to make it work except for Amygdala and Bloodborne. This is actually a boss that locking on, like, might not be the best.
Yeah.
Because it makes you look down a lot.
There's just too many little enemies. It's just gonna.
And I love how the frame rate just shits. Mm-hmm. It shits when you fight this.
It's the Earth Defense Force mentality.
So like you
we're running at a rock solid 30. We're wasting frames. We could get more enemies.
Yeah,
in
there. I bet I could get
you gotta
another
use the
goo
frames.
On here.
Yeah.
A video is scheduled to go up at 9 because I saw some people saying there's no video.
What? No. What?
There is one scheduled to go up at 9. I assume.
I don't know what the fuck
that's
it
odd.
Is.
It's right? O'Dallas.
Oh, it's O'Dallas?
No, it's not.
Oh, okay.
Dallas went up yesterday.
Then it must be Resident Evil.
It's a sneaky surprise attack.
It's gotta be like Resident Evil 6 or
something. I don't know what that means because it's like it's 8 o'clock, not 9, so I don't know how people can think there's
Is it
no
8
video.
O'clock right now?
Yes.
It's, well,
it's totally 8 o'clock.
There's your answer.
All right. Well, we'll check that at 9.
On stream.
We'll upload the video live.
It's kind of like the Celestial Emissary, how it's a bunch of little cute guys.
Yeah,
similar. It's most
yeah,
similar.
Yeah, these are very cute.
Most similar to ROM, I think, by far.
Oh yeah, I guess you're right.
Just because you're fighting a large enemy and there's tons of little ones
and
around.
And the large enemy isn't the problem. It's the little.
It's
enemies
the little enemies that's the problem. Problem, exactly.
Now you can see why I compared so many bosses to Phalanx.
Yes.
What a good first boss. Second boss. It's a second boss.
Well, that depends on how far you get in the tutorial area, because you might not end up.
Yeah.
Spear out of nowhere.
That little spear poking your ass.
Just to remind
just
you.
Just a little bit.
Just to remind you where you
so,
are.
So, the biggest thing about this guy is that as you kill more of them will come off of him.
Oh,
The other thing that I would recommend, Willy, is since you're not blocking a single one of these hits, you might as well two-hand it.
The other thing about...
Unless you plan
to. Well, the other thing about two-handing is that it will allow you to not constantly deflect off of their shields as hard.
Yeah.
Is the fireball good against these guys because they're made out of black oil?
Well, it's not because they're made of oil, but because it's an AoE and they're weak against fire, the fire bombs pretty much obviate the difficulty of this fight.
Do you have any?
Yeah, he's got some.
Why'd you use it?
Because he's mentally locked in right now.
Okay.
Gotta switch when it's safe.
So the best thing about this boss is that it's easy to become safe.
Yeah.
It's slow, it's plodding, you just have to play carefully.
Yeah, just aim where you'll hit, like, the most, like that, yeah.
Shit, you almost killed three in one shot.
Yeah, yeah. Shoot deep.
Yeah, that's good.
That's shallow, but it's not bad.
I thought their fucking shields would protect them.
Not from fire.
Nope.
Oh,
that
Christ.
Was a good one.
Yeah,
that's
the good
go
shit.
Right through
there you go.
So, yeah, you don't even need firebombs for the rest of these punks, because look, you killed so many of them.
You can probably get hits in now on that side.
Man! I really wish that in DS1, that monster at the bottom of the Painted World was, like, more of a boss.
Yeah, well.
Instead of just an homage.
Get him. Oh, he turned around.
That's okay.
Just whack him.
Wooly's faster than that.
Yeah.
Aim at the big one. No.
I saw another group.
Go pick off the solo guys.
Yeah, they're easy to kill. And when you kill them, guys will leech off the big
one.
So,
Pat and Liam, I'm curious. And, Matt, I'm not trying to exclude mm-hmm. you here, but I know you haven't played this game so much.
No, I totally understand. Don't worry about it.
Good hit.
The types of multi-enemy boss fight that we saw in later Souls games, I'm thinking particularly Royal Rat Authority, the Duke's Deer, Freya.
Oh, fuck yeah. That!
Royal Rat Authority.
I fucking hate that.
That's
sorry,
quite all right, and I do too, Pat. Let's make no bones about that. How do you feel mm-hmm. about a fight like this, which is tuned not to have the ads constantly chasing you down and never giving you any breathing room?
I think it's totally fine. I think this is the best one they've ever done, which is frustrating because it's the first one.
That's my feeling.
I think the only other multi-ad boss fight that's good is Ornstein Smog.
I think absolutely this is probably the best multi-enemy boss that I can think of off the top of my head.
Like, I remember...
Unless you count Garl Vinland, but I don't think you do, because one of them's not really an enemy. This is definitely the best. And, like, this is the best type, when it's explicitly designed for that, as opposed to shoving...
As, like, a little tutorial
eight
thing.
Enemies
and, like, right if Wooly went to the corner, like, they couldn't barely do shit against him.
I'm reassured to hear both of you say that, because now I know I'm not crazy.
No, there is an explicit difference between just shoving eight enemies in your face at a time.
Who is out there going, yo, I love these ad battles? They're the fucking sickest.
I shouldn't say everybody, but when I played Dark Souls 2, I got a lot of people yelling at me for complaining about the Royal Rat Authority and the Duke's Deer Freya and calling me an idiot, which has kind of led me to second guess myself.
Like, I saw somebody in the chat say, like, Old Ivory King. And, like, Old Ivory King is cooler than he is fun.
I know a lot of people like the Royal Rat Authority because he's easy.
I thought the reason why you should like Royal Rat Authority is because his name is Royal Rat Authority. Fucking funny.
The name is absolutely great.
Are you guys thinking of Authority or Vanguard?
I thought it was Authority.
Because Authority
I'm talking about Authority, the big one. The Vanguard, well, fine, because that's the whole point of that fight.
Vanguard's okay, I guess, but like...
Sharpstones, yay.
The whole point of the Vanguard fight is it's just basically a game of guess who, and you have to pay attention to which rat is the real one. But, I mean...
All right, it's that one. It's the one with the mohawk.
Go for the big guy.
Okay, go for broke.
So this is my favorite part.
Face it straight.
This is the best part.
It's just an icky piece of jewelry.
Yeah, it's just icky.
Wait, are you just not...
He's got nothing.
He's got nothing?
He's got nothing.
It cannot do anything to you. It has no attacks.
Oh, wow.
It's all about the enemies.
It's all the ads.
It's all about the quantity of enemies.
So that's part of the reason why this is the best one, because the boss can't fight you. It's just a big hitbox.
The idea is just make sure you don't run in. Like, if you try to go in, you'll just hit shields and nothing will happen. You have to go around and around.
You shall obtain the demon soul and a power that is beyond human imagination.
Hey, those little tanks were never there.
You have regained your body. Bring more souls to the demons.
It was there too when you died at the beginning.
The other thing about this fight
little descriptive text.
The ads do not continuously respawn.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
You're human. So, remember what Pat told you to do before whenever you turn human? Go back to the Nexus and jump off a cliff.
I didn't tell him to do that, but if you want to, you could.
To not get invaded?
No, not to not get invaded, but to not fuck up your world tendency. So right now, you started one world tendency away from pure white. By killing the boss and never dying in body form, you're now at pure white, which means that dragon is gone.
If I go back to
the Nexus first.
No, you have to load back in, right?
Once you go back to the Nexus, this world will update to pure white world tendency, and the dragon will be gone, and one or two other things might be different as well.
Yeah, a couple things will be different.
Definitely.
Like people can invade you?
Yes, that's one
people
of the things.
Ones, okay, that's only if you're a human.
Once you beat a boss, you're immune to invasion from that boss room backward.